At defeat Hastian, you were able to successfully not kill Miko and bring him back.
Yay.
Miko is currently... Oh, wait, are we recording?
I am now. But I started recording when you started your backstory stuff, Michael.
So after rescuing Miko, you are sending him to rest in the Bellows of the Last Breath. Captain Grimzod has graciously offered to keep an eye on him while you all take some time to recuperate from your recent adventures, seeing as you've all been through the ringer quite a bit. He suggests that you take the day to sit down, relax, enjoy the atmosphere while you're here. It's not every day you get a chance to enjoy the Silverwind Isles. And with that being said, he suggests that you all find yourself some appropriate wear for this sort of atmosphere.
By the way, Michael, we're still on the battle map.
Oh, yeah, let me move you over to the Tiki Hut. Hey, is the music playing for you guys?
Yep.
Yes.
Weird, it's not playing for me. Hold on.
Oh, yeah, did you have a different game open before this?
Oh, for a moment, yeah.
Yeah, that fucks up your music. I found that out as a DM.
Oh, weird. All right, let me just refresh.
Well, it's because it's trying to load the old game, right? Not the new game.
Mm. Oh, yeah, look at that. I'm in Humblewood.
Yeah, that's what I thought. See, it's trying to reload your shit from Humblewood.
Why are you in Humblewood?
Why not?
Fair enough.
Mainly just stealing some assets from Humblewood.
Fair.
Because we're going to find out the owner of the tiki bar is Roko.
Hell and no. No, snowball's chance in hell on that one. Alright, let me get this started proper. There it is. So by the way, let me give you guys your tokens so that you can throw them into your sheets real quick. Not the right one. Hold on. There we go. Sorry, just one more moment.
That's all right.
I know one of these is O-dubs, but I'm not.
By the way, Michael, you'll have to do mine because my roll 20 is filled.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because all the stuff. Because I no longer subscribe, right?
Yeah. All right. Well, everyone besides you, put your token in. Just checking, Keith, you have a copy of Winchester's original token, right?
Let me double check myself. I was thinking about that. I mean, I should have sent it to you before. You should have a copy on our chat, because, again, you had to upload it.
There you go, Michael. It's the default token, not the normal one, so...
Let me check here.
Should be... Token. There it is. There it is!
Alright, there you go, Heath.
No, oh, thanks, Michael. I just...
Hey, bro.
Tokens, there we are. Winchester, where are you? I think I... Oh, I'd be amazed if I don't have a Winchester backup. Yeah, I got Winchester back up. I'm okay.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
I'm sorting through all my artwork. Takes a minute.
It's all good, all good. Alright, and then I'll throw Maggie's out in the field, because she needs one. Boom.
Killer.
Alright. So, as you begin your vacation day, where would you like to start?
Mimosas?
Fuck yes.
Are you going to get beachwear first, or are you going for mimosas first?
Actually, yeah.
Probably go shopping first.
Is this Vegas rules?
Define Vegas rules.
AKA, we're allowed to drink on the drink in public?
Yes. Yes, you can.
Fantastic. We'll grab mimosas as we walk towards swimwear.
Perfect, for sure.
All right. You guys stop in for a quick round at the Silverboro Dragon Inn. Mm-hmm. Or the Silver Dragon Burrow Inn. And grab a round of mimosas. I'm not going to bother charging you guys for that. That's just pitiful at this point for you guys. But you start making your way through this nice, lovely sort of like silver beach town. And you take a couple minutes to like ask around, be like, oh, where can we get like some stuff? Because, you know, this is a touristy area and there's plenty of shops. Can someone roll me a quick sort of either... Roll me an investigation check, someone.
I can do it.
Hey.
Just shouldn't be Winchester. He's not terrible, but he's not proficient.
Also, Maggie, if you ever want to roll for something, just let me know.
A 9.
Killer. Ooh.
By the way, Megan, do you want like one of us to stream the episode, the map for you, so you can see at least everything?
Was that a yes, Maggie?
Huh?
Do you want me to stream for you so you can see everybody's tokens and everything?
What? You guys were talking?
My god. Yes.
It just cuts out every so often.
Fair. I'll stream for you.
I'm sorry, I rolled a 9.
With a 9. It takes you a little bit. You kind of go by this, like place. So you go by, like, this little, like, out in the sand, sort of, like, out in the street, sort of, like, little vendor. You see kind of, like, this, human woman, kind of older, probably around her 50s. Tan skin, weather worn, and she kind of looks at you and she goes, she's like, I have a plenty of amazing top of the line, like, swimsuits that I could fit you all with.
I come over in my mech suit. Ching, ting, ting.
How are you, a diver?
Sure.
Probably better to stay out of water there, my good chummy, but might want to avoid the rust.
I think I'm a bit beach person.
Alright. She starts throwing some outfits together for you guys. Someone just make me a insight check.
Sure, I can do that. 20.
Winchester, you're getting the feeling this is probably not a quality shop, like, in the slightest. You're like, taking a look at some for wares, and it's like, I think there's a hole in that shirt. And that bra is literally just two coconuts tied together with twine.
Okay, real.
Yeah, Winchester kind of just leans over. It's like, I think we could do better than this, honestly. Lucid, perhaps we should shop about a bit first.
Those coconuts aren't even dried. They still have the food part of it in it.
I fell for the gimmick. I'll admit it. I saw, Straw Shack. Surely they'll have, like, quality stuff there.
Yeah, sometimes a Straw Shack is just that. perhaps we should continue this again and try another place. You could try... how about you there, anybody else would like to try to take the lead on this one, or should I?
I'll do it.
Yeah, fantastic. I will tap you on the thing and guidance you.
All right, Ballast. Roll me an investigation check.
Yeah, D4 to that.
All right, that's 24. Pretty good. That's pretty good. All right. With that, Ballast, you start asking around a little bit, and eventually... actually, pretty quickly, you hear tale of a pretty, like, favored shop by the locals and tourists alike, known as the Gilded Pepper.
Oh,
no,
I had to go.
Oh,
okay.
There's a gilded place nearby, so they must be unionized, so that's a good sign.
Ah, jolly good.
Yeah, I'll bring the party there.
You start leading the way as you take your time and make your way to the Gilded Feather. And we are going to change maps here. Whoa!
Dun, dun, dun. Battle map!
Oh, we lost Maggie, I think.
No!
Maggie!
This is a massive rug.
It's a very big score.
Not that big.
It's 15 feet across.
10 feet, really.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
That includes the 5 feet of movement. It's 15, bud.
It's probably 13. But yeah.
Okay, if you want to find a 13-foot rug that you just lay down with this, and it isn't a fucking mint, you know what I mean?
I would say, I mean, 15-foot across wide's not that crazy. There are wet rugs like that.
I understand that they exist. You do not need to, we don't need to argue that.
Fair.
Fucking rug half the size is like 50 bucks.
If you gotta look at that, man, it's like we have like 5 foot long scrolls over here. So.
Exactly.
Ah, man. Very sad that Maggie's internet is dying today.
Yeah, I know. They're the most excited for this episode.
I know! That's why I don't want to do anything without them.
We can give it
Maggie!
A minute. Maggie's back!
Maybe.
We can hope.
Maggie, you're not speaking.
We might have to pivot to something else today, guys. I'm sorry.
We could just do the beach episode, man.
I mean, to be fair, I kind of agree with Michael. Maggie was the one who wanted this the most. I also feel bad if we got to cut because Maggie's not here.
I mean, I'm cool. with whatever we do. I'm now home. I was able to get the paperbacks. I didn't kill an old woman. I'm happy.
Huzzah!
And I'm cool.
Literally, it was like, I waited like 10 minutes in a Lowe's. Like, if Maggie was on time, I would have been like 20 minutes late. It was crazy. But, I mean, silver lining, I guess. I was on time, technically.
Yeah, I felt bad if Maggie was the one who missed it, because this was the thing she was really excited for.
Can you hear me? Why the fuck did
you... Yeah, we can hear you.
The headphone's not working.
We can hear you just fine.
Well, Maggie, you're alive!
You're very echoey, though.
Yeah. I'm gonna take my headphones out.
Damn!
I'm doing some tests.
Alright, get those tests done.
I'll see.
Test. Oh, fuck.
Okay. We can hear you.
There we go, that sounds
better?
Proper. Yeah, that sounds good.
It's fucking perfect. Okay, we're good then.
Alright.
I have to do this on my phone.
Better than nothing, I suppose.
Yep.
And the plus side is not combat, so it shouldn't be too big a problem.
Okay, killer. Okay, killer.
Anyways, Michael, you may continue.
Huzzah! Alright, so as you all are walking in, and who is not in the shop?
Donnie.
Okay. I was genuinely tabbed out because I was waiting for Maggie to come back. I'm sorry.
I'll just give you shit, man. Anyway. So, as you all walk into this shop, first thing you notice is that the walls are kind of made of sort of a thinner sort of wood. There's a nice breeze that kind of goes through this area. And as you walk in, you see a lovely decorated interior. Carpets laid out, shelves very well stocked, and behind a counter sitting on a chair, you see what seems to be this person.
Oh my god! They're so cute!
As she sees you all enter, she says, "Oh, hello! Welcome to the Guild of Feather! Come in!
Oh, good day there, madam. My word, aunt, you have such lovely plumage, I must admit."
Oh, thank you. I try to take care. I always tell my husband a little, you know, seed oil goes a long way, but, you know, he doesn't want to listen. He's like, it's just gonna, you know, I'm just gonna ruffle my feathers anyway. And he said he does, but that's why I love it.
Yeah, very well done. I was wondering if you would be able to supply us with some sort of appropriate wear for the weather and beach here for the moment. We found ourselves here by rather a fortuitous accident, and we're planning to spend rather a day or two.
Oh, of course, we can do all sorts of things. This is kind of a general shop, so we have everything any prospecting visitor could ever wish for. So, give me one moment as it tends to be more of my husband's specialty than mine. And you can see her kind of like with a kind of like big flap of her wings, she kind of like scales up this ladder in almost a single bound. And you hear her kind of like say, "Honey, we have guests and they are in need of your assistance." And you hear her voice go, "All right, come along." And she kind of like hops down and she says, "He'll be right out.
Oh.
In the meantime, feel free to look around, see if anything catches your eye."
Oh, very well.
And strewn before you, you see a bunch of stuff. A lot of it's like, sort of like knickknacks and stuff like that. You see like a little shelf that has like some local fruits, another one that seems to have various vials. Some of them seem to be perfumes. Well, there's a few that look like they may actually be potions, perhaps? One shelf you see what seems to be scrolls and books and whatnot, kind of like tourist guides, you know, like, oh, where should you eat, you know, some about local history, that sort of thing. And another one, you see pieces of jewelry, bits and baubles, nothing too... Some of it looks nice, actually. But a lot of it tends to incorporate, like, more of natural elements, like seashells and sort of, like, stuff that you could probably gather was probably locally obtained.
Oh, do they have, like, a puka shell anklet?
Yes.
Okay, I'll get that.
Alright, we'll say 2 silver.
Killer.
Do you have access to your sheet?
No.
Okay, I'm going to take the gold out and or the silver out and then we will add that. What was it? Puka shell?
Puka shell. But it's as the anklet, not the necklace. The necklace is kinda tacky.
Shell. Anklet. Not sure if I spelled any of that correctly, but we will go with it. But yeah, you find that. That's a nice little accessory. She goes, oh, that will look lovely on.
Oh, you're too kind.
Anyone else looking at some sort of knickknacks or baubles?
I guess Winchester would start looking over some sunglasses.
You do find a nice pair of sunglasses. There are some that are like clearly like dark like glass sort of stuff. But then you also see one that looks a little different, and you take a closer look at it, and she sees you look, and she's like, oh, those ones are actually made with real volcanic glass, obsidian.
Oh my, but isn't that quaint?
Oh, they're lovely.
Very dangerous.
Oh no, I promise you, they are polished to a mirror shine. You will not, there's no chance of cuts or fragments of glass getting in your eyes. We make sure that our vendors are well respected.
I would hope so. How much would you these cost me about?
The obsidian ones?
Sure.
They're a little on the pricier side. They are considered more of a jewelry accessory, but we would happily sell that for about 10 gold.
Jesus Christ, that's more than an entire noble's outfit.
These are really nice sunglasses.
It's fair, but Jesus, man. For something he's going to spend for the weekend, it's probably more. I could spend an entire year's salary of a peasant to buy these sunglasses.
The peasants are coming here?
That's not what I said. Why not? Winchester's got more money than knows what to do with.
Alright.
The shades are Gucci.
They are Gucci. And remove 10 gold and you can have obsidian sunglasses.
What's gonna happen is we're gonna fight an enemy whose like weakness is obsidian. We're gonna fight the zombies from fucking Game of Thrones, and these are gonna become clutch.
Yeah, it's like we can make like a little spear out of these.
Yeah, just in the middle of wild space, we just find a bunch of white walk.
You never know.
Alright, anyone else looking at anything of interest?
I mean, Donnie's looking at various shelves for anything that looks mildly interesting. He's just been awkwardly quiet the entire time.
You're kind of standing right now in front of a table that has like a couple vials on it. There's some perfumes on there and what seem to be like a few miscellaneous potions.
Alright. What kind of perfumes, I guess?
You see various types of perfume. You're seeing, like, something... There's, like, a simple lavender one, but there's also something called Angel's Tears. You get one... You see one that says Summer's Breeze. Some pretentious shit like that.
Donnie is going to try every single one.
Alright. You pick... You pick it up, you kind of do the tss.
Yep.
Alright, is there any particular scent that you find enjoyable, Donnie?
Bold of you to assume he's going for scent. He just wants to see what it smells like.
Oh, okay.
Every single one of them.
They smell like perfume, man. Like, have you ever smelled perfume?
Yes, and I hate it.
Yeah, there you go.
Whoa, some of them are good.
Some of them are good. A large majority of them are obnoxious.
Oh, yeah.
True, real.
Hey, Donnie, what's your passive perception?
13.
Awesome. All right, anyone else do anything?
Checking out these books and scrolls.
All right, you take a look. A lot of it seems to be like, sort of like, you know, tour guide information, but you also see some like historical stuff. You see some stuff on like some of the, like the local customs here, stuff like that nature.
I'm gonna pick up the pamphlet, I guess, about local customs and see what they got to offer.
Okay, yeah, you see a lot. There's a lot of it's kind of like aiming towards like the silver beaches here, but there's also other things like traditional sort of like dances, feasting areas, kind of some of the local culture here. You're also seeing things that are for sort of like a kind of like a. There seems to be like a weird local game here, where two teams, and the numbers can vary, but it can go as small on 2v2, and then sometimes they can bump it up to 5v5. But it's basically a game where they hit some sort of like larger ball to each other across a net, and if the ball hits the ground on one team's side, the other team gets a point.
It's kind of the basic premise.
How much is the pamphlet?
The pamphlet, that one is only like 3 copper. It's more or less like a little handout thing.
Okay, then. I was gonna say, like, I want to get one so I can, like, bring it with us as we walk and talk and figure out what we want to do.
Right. Anyone else looking at anything?
Yeah, is there any, like, commemorative magnets or anything like that?
For real?
Sure, yeah. There's kind of, like, this nice little stone one that, that kind of says, life is a beach.
And then you die. Okay.
Right. I will purchase that and equip it to my armor.
Okay. We'll say it's a magnet, so we'll say 7 copper.
Make me have to break up silver now? Yeah, I got it.
Okay. Anyone else buy any knickknacks or anything like that?
Like a pamphlet for like local bars.
So that's like what I got.
Lucia's pamphlet already kind of covers that.
Killer. Perfect.
Alright, and as you guys are kind of like getting your knickknacks together, finally you see come down a kind of a larger, burlier sort of crow man. He says, hi, my name's Mac. I hear you guys are looking for some new outfits.
Yeah.
Yeah, just local swimwear and such.
Oh, perfect. We have all sorts of options for all shapes and sizes. Here, and he just kind of like starts going up to each of you, and he goes, okay, he'll go up to you first, Winchester. Do you have anything in mind, particular style, anything like that?
I prefer full body. I have a bit of delicate skin in the sun, so a bit more coverage is always appreciated.
Sure, we can do a one-piece, two-piece. That should be pretty easy. You seem like a man who enjoys the classics. How about just a classic white and blue stripe?
Oh, fantastic. Stripes are so slimming.
They are. And it's like, okay. And he just kind of like pulls out like one of the measures that the tailors use, and he gets your measurements. It's like, all right, perfect. I can have that ready for you in a little bit. Who else? And Odeb just kind of walks up. It's like, Odeb not really need new swimwear, but Odeb would like new shirt. Sure. I can get that for you. Anything you want. Fish. I want fish on it. I can do that. How about you, good sir? Seem a little heavy in terms of your clothing options. You looking for something lighter, or?
I'm assuming that's a ballast?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, a pair of swim trunks, please.
Alright, do you want a sun hat as well?
Sure. Okay. As large as you can make it. Almost a sun blanket, but on my head.
That I can do. Alright, what about, and he walks over to you, Donnie, he's like, no offense, you look a little on the paler side. Do you need some coverage as well?
Not really, no. What is the most basic option?
I can get you a floral print shirt with some trunks.
Sure.
Alright. Walks up to you, Lucius. Anything for you, sir?
Just something casual, maybe like a linen open buttoned down shirt and like some nice trunks. Do you have anything, like what kind of designs do you have? Is there a certain trend here?
There's not really much in the way of trends. This tends to be a more popular tourist destination for those with scales, dragonborn, lizard folk, the occasional kobolds. They tend to enjoy the weather here along with the silver sand, sort of more of sort of medicinal properties that's really good at treating scales.
Okay. So then I guess a basic pair of, like, trunks then? Like, do you have a sagey kind of color?
Yeah, I can do that. And then anything else? Anything else you want, sir? Or...
Oh no, that'll be it for me.
Alright, and he walks up to you, Varanani, and says, and you, miss, is there anything I can get you?
Like, it's watermelon colored, the top part all pink, with a gold heart accent in the middle, and then a matching, like, bottom, kind of in that striped green.
Okay.
And a little, like, skirt cover, that'd be cute, and maybe a nice sun hat, very big.
Like your friend over there, yeah?
Exactly.
Okay, I can do that. Sounds... Alright, give me a couple minutes. I think some of this stuff I should be able to just pull out and make minor adjustments and get that to you. Yeah, give me about 10-15 minutes. I should have all your stuff ready.
Okay, perfect.
And he kind of like heads back upstairs. The lady goes, thank you, Mac. And he goes, no problem, Pan. And she says, when he leaves, she just kind of coos for a second and goes, oh, isn't he the greatest?
Wonderful.
You're so cute.
Oh, well, you know. Well, we live in an island paradise, and, you know, he's been my little lovebird for about 10 years married now, so...
Ah, indeed. Very, very good.
And she'll just kind of, like, start just gabbing about, like... her and his story, how they met, you know, their first day, all that stuff.
So Michael, do I know how old Era Cockra tend to live?
You're not actually sure if these are Era Cockra.
No, fair enough.
Yeah, they lack the, like, back wings that most Era Cockra have. This is, something else. There's a lot of weird species out there. You're not really...
Yeah, well, I mean, would Winchester know what they were was kind of the question, I suppose.
Roll me an intelligence check.
Since he is worldly, universally traveled, he's got a chance at this, I would imagine.
Sure!
Intelligence? Can I guide us myself?
Nah. You've heard stories of, like, various sort of, like, avian-based people out in the world. Maybe some derivative of Kenku? Perhaps? But you can't be 100% certain. It's a big universe.
They're space birds.
That's basically all you need to know.
They're the bird people from Flash Gordon.
But after a few minutes of her just kind of talking your ear on and you guys just going, yep, uh-huh. Oh, that's so lovely. He didn't. Oh, you.
That's crazy.
I know.
Damn, that's crazy.
Eventually, he comes back down, and he's like, all right, here you go. Do you guys need a place to change? We got rooms over there. It's kind of like gestures, kind of like some doors over here.
Yes, please. I'm kind of dying in these slacks. It's so hot.
Oh, and Odub just kind of... And Odub just kind of chimes in your mind when you say that, and he just goes, wouldn't it be hot if wearing dress? Breeze real nice.
Exactly.
I'm just gonna slowly turn to Odub. Say nothing, then continue walking.
If Odub could, like, if Odub's beak could, like, morph to smile, you have a feeling he'd have the biggest fucking grin right now.
Just a bird smirk?
Yep. But eventually, you guys all get a chance to get changed. You're in your new gear. It's nice. It fits pretty well. He says, all right, for all of your swimwear, though, that's going to be about each of your senses. On average, you guys owe me about a gold apiece. I assume you're a group. If you're paying individually, I can break it down.
No, of course, no. We could pay as one.
Great. Makes my life a lot simpler.
I'll give him a platinum. Make life easy.
Do you need change, sir?
No. Well, I will be getting change, but that's besides the point.
Is that a yes?
No, it's a no. I'm good.
Thank you kindly, sir. Alright, is there anything else we can help you folks with?
I believe we're doing just fine. Everything is going well.
Alright.
So she's been regaling us about your relationship, so my first question is, where did the two of you meet?
Oh, we met on another planet. It's called Zikram. Basically, we had met there, what is it, a little over 10 years now. No, not 10. She's like, no, we've been married 10. She's like, right, I'm sorry. We met there about 15 years ago. We were still fairly young. And basically, we met kind of in a smaller town, just kind of a way station for traveling folks. Kind of caught her eye across the bar and built up the courage to go ask for a drink. And things kind of just went from there.
Good to hear. And that's exactly what she said, right?
Yeah, more or less.
But you're double checking they're not scamming us?
I'm double checking to make sure the guy didn't forget anything aboard. As is typical.
Trying to call out the wife. Trying to call
out. Call out the husband. I assumed the wife got it right.
Ends up pretty much one for one. She did mention a little bit of an embarrassing fact that when he first approached her, he kind of said something a little dumb along the lines of, man, you're... You know, he basically fumbled the pass. He basically was like, man, your feathers are very pretty.
I don't know, he got the girl. Is it that much of a fumble?
Fair point.
I mean, it's probably one of them charming fumbles, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. But yeah. With that being said, he bids you all farewell, and if you guys had anything else you needed to get, he's happy to get it for you.
Winchester would just grab a sun hat off the rack, look at it, and just kind of nod at him, point at it. Since we played 10 platinum, he's assuming he doesn't have to worry about it.
He just gives you a thumbs up. You're good.
Puts his ears through.
Perfectly acceptable. And yeah, with that, you guys are doing good. As you head out, you kind of wander into the streets. Do you guys have any particular destination you're looking for, or are you kind of like you know, just moseying it about, just kind of seeing what's around.
Oh, I think Maggie was trying to talk.
I think Maggie just died again.
No! Oh,
Maggie is not here anymore. Man, poor Maggie.
No!
What?
Maggie?
Maggie, you alive?
Hello. They typed hello in the chat.
Hello?
Test.
There we go. We can hear you.
Okay. We got you.
Okay. Damn. Yeah, I cut out for like the last couple minutes.
All you missed was Winchester by a hat.
That's a killer.
Yes, and you guys are now basically set to roam the streets. Do you have a particular destination you guys want to go to first, or are you just kind of walking the streets, kind of seeing what's around?
I mean, Lucius has a pamphlet, so I suppose he would be the first to suggest something.
Yeah, I was waiting until we were, like, able to, like, get out and talk and peruse. Wait for Maggie to come back. Yeah, as we, like, walk outside, Lucia's like, oh, there's a bunch of different things we could do here. Like, there's, like, this game that you could play. They have dancing here, which I thought was pretty cool. We could check out some of the local, like, natural sites if you want to go sightseeing.
Well, that does sound rather fascinating.
I think there's water sports in here, too.
Oh, polo. A bit of polo, then.
That and so much.
Who's going to be Marco?
Yeah.
a reference that makes no sense in this universe.
But yes, as you all sort of just start heading out onto the streets. Hold on. Put yourselves at the top over here, for those of you who can. Okay, and then, thank you. Alright, and as you start, like, wandering down this street, you're kind of wandering down the street with kind of, like, various different, like, merchants set up in little shacks, that sort of thing, on the streets. You see a lot of, like, as stated before, you see a lot of dragonborn and sort of, like, lizard folk, kobolds, kind of, like, in the streets. Kind of, like, this is clearly their atmosphere, right? And as you guys start walking down, notable things you see is you see kind of like a gif at one side. You see kind of a man with like cards, tarot cards out in front of him. You see this little motherfucker just kind of, he seems like he's just kind of bouncing a bit. And then you do see another Dorwar, kind of just like, with a blade at each of his sides. In the distance, though, you can hear what seems to be the sound of some music. Let me actually put some stuff on for that, actually. So, is there anything you guys would like to do walking down the street?
Can I go to the tarot card guy?
I also would like to go to the tarot card guy. Sorry, that was a
follow Lucius.
Alright. Anyone else going to the tarot card guy? Or you guys want, does anyone want to check out something else?
What's the gif doing out of curiosity? Just by a quick glance.
You see the gif, and they seem to be kind of like running a little stall, and you see, as you kind of like peer over, seems like they're selling various types of tobacco.
And Winchester would probably head over to the tobacco stand. He could refill his pipe.
As you walk up, she kind of looks at you and goes, "Ho ho! It's good to see another gif out here. Not too many of us in this region."
I do believe it. It is a nice fall vacation getaway sort of thing, though.
Oh, definitely. And let me tell you, people here, they do enjoy their vacations, and they enjoy to spend money on those vacations.
Guaranteed. That seemed like the leisurely bit of a tourist trap.
Oh, definitely. But while you're here, good tourist, can I interest you in some of this tobacco? Some of the finest in the galaxy, I assure you.
Oh, of course. Let me take a peek at that, and he'll give it a good whiff.
You take a good look, and there's actually a few different selections here. A lot of it seems to actually be using some of the local crops grown here.
Now, the real question is, Michael, is this happy tobacco?
Happy tobacco?
You seriously don't know the term?
Yep.
Devil's lettuce, marijuana, push.
There's some you can see some kind of like in the back. It's not really like on full display, but it's visible.
Island weed.
Hey, in this part of the galaxy, it could very well be legal. I mean, it's legal a lot of places now.
Sticky icky, if you will.
Bit of Mary Jane.
Yeah.
Yep.
But she's like, "Yeah, no, a lot of this is good stuff. Some of it's got a bit of a sweeter flavor to it. Others a bit more mild and savory. We also have a couple of other more exotic blends in the back, if you're willing to take a look."
Do you have anything that would help someone, you know, relax?
That I can help you with. And she says, "Yeah, come on." And she, like, kind of opens up her stall a bit and kind of leads you to, like, the back portion of it. And she says, "Yes, we got a couple of things to help relax." And she kind of starts taking you through it. So you do find a couple blends. One she likes to call Thodarian Thunderfuck.
Good name, Michael. Good name.
Thank you. It's more of a sort of stimulating sort of weed. It really kind of gets you a bit more energized, makes you kind of giddy and happy. And if you got a bit of a, if you're trying to impress a lover, it supposedly helps with stamina.
This Viagra weed.
There's also
an election lasting for more than 48 hours. Please contact your local gift dealer of weed.
Okay, Jay, you get a point for that joke. She also gives you sort of the what she likes to call lazy coconut. More of an indigo sort of thing. Really, just lets you mellow out. You kind of feel a bit lighter when you smoke this, and it also, like, you tend to also get a bit of a munchies.
I think Winchester would grab that one based off the, unless there's a third description you want to give me, Michael.
Yes, actually, there is the Beryllium Power Dome. Which, if you'd like to make a history check on that one.
18. That's pretty high.
So you actually recognize the name Beryllium Power Dome, and that's basically a sort of gladiatorial ring in the middle of an asteroid belt. Essentially, what it is known for, basically housing combatants who fight exotic and very dangerous creatures gathered from the galaxy. And she goes on to describe the weed for you, and she's like, "Oh yes, this one is gonna really make you feel, whew, like you're gonna feel a bit of, gonna feel like a big strong man, you know." And she kind of like describes it. Basically, it's something that people take to like hype themselves up a bit more. Like, this is not something that people take to relax.
Smelling salt.
I was about to say bath salt, so it's just fucking...
Yeah, more like that. It's basically
take...
something...
Yeah, it's not what he's looking for. The second one's the one he's looking for. He wants mellow chill and munchy time.
But imagine the monsters you could catch on that.
Look, Winchester doesn't need drugs to go hunting monsters.
Maggie, is that you breathing?
Oh my god, I'm laying in bed right now. I'm so sorry.
You're good. I heard it like a few times. I'm like, am I going insane?
No, I was hearing the echo too. I thought it sounded like a fan, actually.
Liz, she goes, she's like, all right, how much are you looking for?
I would
probably recommend a bit more than the average person.
Of course. I was exactly, were you selling party packs?
I don't sell party packs, but I could sell you a good amount for a good deal.
Of course. How much would you say,
Ten what?
Sorry, I thought Maggie was saying something. About, I'd say 10 golds worth.
Thank you.
She goes, yay. Well, for 10 golds worth, I could probably get you... This is some of the nicer stuff, but... For a fair gift, tell you what, 10 gold, I'll give you 20 ounces.
You know what? Let's make it, 40 ounces for 20 gold, if that's okay.
Say that again?
20, he's basically doubling it. 20 gold for 20, for the double the amount.
Alright, I don't have... I'll get you 30 of the one that you want. I could also throw in some of the other stuff if you want to try something different.
We'll stick with the 30. We'll take the 15 then, and for the 15 gold, just for the sake of, we're trying to have a bit of a chill moment. We had a bit of a rapscallion time, and I believe everybody could use some downtime.
Understood. And shakes your hand, takes the gold, packs that up for you, gives it to you. Is like, anything else I can get for you?
How about just some basic tobacco for the pipe?
All right, and you can fill up your tobacco stores with some nicer stuff. I'll say you can get a silver or a single gold should set you for a little while. Odub kind of comes over, looks at what you're buying, nods in approval. Looks at it, gives it a smell. Kind of gives a, not bad.
I figured everyone could use a bit of a relaxation.
Not Lucius. Lucius not like smokes.
We could always break into a brownie.
Like your style. Walks away. Regroups with the rest of the group. Ballas, who are you following?
Ballas is actually going to go off on his own. He wants to be the responsible person going to a beach day and wants to get towels, sunscreen, and stuff for both hot dogs, burgers, and like a craw boil, basically.
Okay, as you start like walking down, you're probably going to end up talking to this guy down here. And he goes, hey! Hi!
I am not ready for this interaction. Hi, alright, I need meats and seafood.
Meats and seafood? Can do. You looking for tuna? You looking for sea bass? You looking for... What do you got? You looking for anything special?
I don't think we have any shellfish allergies, so we're going to do a craw boil.
Nice. Can do that for you. All right. And he starts, like, going to the back, and you hear, like, the sound of, like, things being rummaged around as he brings out kind of, like, a nice case of crawfish.
All right. We're going to want some hot dogs, burgers. I don't think chips are good for the beach. I mean, I like chips, but no. We're going to do burgers and hot dogs.
Burgers, hot dogs, alright. Anything else I can get for you, big guy?
A table, some disposable plates, and a bunch of extra towels, and a parasol. Like an umbrella for the beach.
Sure. And he like, just goes out and just starts grabbing all that crap from the back. Just.
Do you sell liquor?
Liquor? Nah. You gotta talk to that guy over there as he points to the door war.
Did you steal an icebox? Sorry, do you have an icebox?
I am... Icebox? Yeah, I can get you an Icebox. How much you want? Okay, and you got, like, how many? How
many? I did it. I mean, if you want. Yeah, alright. So how much is that gonna all run me?
He kinda, like, quickly, like, just jots some stuff down and goes, okay, terrible, do that. Okay, the crawfish burgers, fry, crawfish burgers, hot dogs, towels, parasol, disposable table plates, and the big ice box. You are looking at a total of 20 gold.
All right. Give me a second ice box, and here's an extra 20 gold on top.
Yes, sir! And he goes ravaging through the back, and he's going to be like, give me one moment on the extra ice box, sir.
And he can see just I'll go purchase some alcohol while you go get it. Yeah,
sounds good, sounds good. And he, like, jumps out of his stall, like, closes it, locks it real quick, and you can just see him just kind of
I figured.
We will get back to your interactions with that door war in a minute. Let's us go over to the rest of the group. Lucius, Varanada, Donnie, you kind of walk up to this sort of, like, dashing-looking gentleman with cards in his hands, and he says, good evening and hello. I was expecting you, though you're a little later than I thought. Come, come, sit. I think I know what you're here for.
Yeah?
You all are looking for your fortunes, yes?
Absolutely.
Well, I was curious as to what kind of fortunes you give.
Can I do something before this interaction continues?
Sure, what do you want to do, Donnie?
Can I roll an active perception check? I want to watch this fucker like a hawk.
Just to see if he's like... if he's like sleight-of-handing anything?
Yes.
Okay, I will make me a perception check. 15, pretty good. Alright.
Donnie, just stay quiet.
Alright, just... But he says, what kind of fortunes do I tell? Well, I tell your fortune, of course. Come, come, come. Sit. It's the future that I glean. And he offers you a seat, kind of like on a pillow.
Oh, well, thank you. I'll sit down.
Alright, he says, so, young man from the stars, I can tell. Tell me, what is it you seek?
I guess. Let's go something basic. Do you do love reading? Or, like, see into, like, a love life kind of foretelling?
See into a love life.
Donnie's gaze slowly shifts to Lucius.
Do you hear wedding bells in the future?
Well. Love is a fickle matter, my dear friend. Love's a fickle matter, my dear friend. It's as changing as the winds here. And your fate is not sealed in that regard. I give more fortunes in terms of your life's overall trajectory.
Okay, real.
The smaller details are needed, though. But, if you're interested, for the price of 2 gold, I am happy to take a look and see what I can see in your future.
Donnie, do you want to get your future run? I'll put down 4 gold.
Alright. Well, as you're the one paying, we'll start off with you, good sir. Sound good?
Sure. Enlighten me.
Alright, and by the way, my name's Durango, as he holds out his hand.
Lucius, and I'll shake it.
Alright, you shake it, he says, alright, Lucius, let's take a look and see. And as he does, you can see him kind of fan out his cards for a moment in his hands, and then just kind of slide them across the table. He says, now, Lucius, I need you to focus on your hope. I need you to first look at your past. Focus on it. Find your most defining moment in your life thus far.
Okay.
All Alright, you're thinking of it?
Yep.
Alright. He kind of sweeps his hand across the table, and picking up all the cards. You then seem kind of like bridge shuffle them for a moment, and then kind of like do that thing where he kind of like pulls back on them, and kind of like, and they kind of like shoot into one hand into the other. And then he kind of like brings them all into fold, taps them on the table, and says, "Then, Lucius." And you can see him kind of like close his eyes, feel the cards for a moment, and then pull one out and places it in front of you. And he pulls out what seems to be the stars.
Sorry, say that again?
He pulls out the card, the stars.
Ooh, okay.
He looks at you and he goes, "I see. Yours was a past one bright burning, however, there was a dimness to it. You were missing something, something important, despite having many great things given to you. And as great as it was, it had to fade, leading you to your present." He looks at you and is like, So you're taking a bit of a downturn from your status quo, I see.
Suppose you could say that.
Very well. Now, my friend, focus on your present. Think of the things that have been happening to you recently, the things that are going to happen to you soon. They kind of like start shuffling the cards. Do you have it locked in?
Yes.
Good. And you can see him like tap the cards, and he actually flicks one out of the deck, catches it, and puts it down. And he sees the chariot. And it's facing away from him. And he says, "Seems you're on destination for a conflict of some sort." Tell me, is there something that's on the horizon that might be coming for you in a way?
I can think of a couple things.
I see. Fear not. This doesn't necessarily mean you're doomed. It just means that whilst there is a turbulent time coming ahead, it's going to be up to you to determine whether it breaks you or strengthens you. Only time will tell. However, I can take a little peek into your future. Now, I want you to peer as far into the future as you can. I want you to try to grasp at the uncertainty of the universe.
Alright.
And he kind of like takes the cards, flips them over, kind of does some card tricks, and then he kind of like holds it up in front of his face, and then with a flick of his wrist, he actually throws all the cards into the air, closes his eyes, and then reaches out and grabs one. And he sets it down. And you look out to it. My mom's giving me a text. Okay, sorry about that. Where was I?
My future tarot card.
Oh, yes, sorry. So, they pick it up. So they reach out, they grab it, while it's still fluttering in the air. Donnie, I'm gonna give you with your 19. You're not really seeing any sort of, like, obvious sort of, you're not seeing any sort of, like, obvious sleight of hand where he's, like, trying to force it.
Does he seem like he's using magic?
Roll me a crown check.
Alright. Wow, just damn on his shit tonight, I guess.
Indeed. Okay, so what you see, you do feel the presence of some sort of magic. However, you're not gathering like it's deceptive or misleading anyway. There's something actually here.
He's actually okay. He's not. He's actually got something going on. All right.
Yes. And you see what seems to be the card Judgment put in front of you. And he looks at it and goes, "Oh, okay. Interesting. It seems you're going to have to make a very tough decision sometime in the future. I cannot tell how far ahead this decision will have to be, but it is one that you will have to make, and whatever decision you make will follow you from then on out."
It sounds so ominous.
Well, it could be a good thing, but... And you see how the card is faced away from you? And he looks down at it and he says, "That doesn't give me a good feeling." Still though, I could be wrong. I've been wrong before. Not often, but it has happened occasionally.
Right now, do him. And I'm just gonna, like, gesture, like, to Johnny. Donnie.
Oh, sure. And he, like, picks up his cards. You actually see him kind of, like, twirl his hands for a second, and his cards actually, like, pile back into his hand. Yes, sir.
Oh.
Take a seat.
Takes a seat.
Alright. And he kind of like starts shuffling the cards. He's like, "Alright, I'm more or less going to ask you the same thing. So, let's start with your past. What is your defining moment? Think of it. Don't tell me. Just think of it."
All right.
And as you're thinking of it, he starts twirling the cards around, doing this and that, until eventually, he pulls out a card. And it is not one that you were expecting. You see him pull out the Lovers.
Huh?
Loser.
Huh? This is Liam confused, huh?
Jeez. Is that what I said? You see him pull out the Lovers.
I knew it.
Adi just looks in complete astonishment.
He says, "Well, I see that in your past you have been loved greatly by another. Little someone waiting for you back home, then, I take it."
Whoa.
We just found out Lucius is a homewrecker.
Damn.
He's just staring at it. Just
Lucius
like,
just lamenting because it may have not been the first time.
Oh my goodness.
Are you okay, sir? We haven't even gotten to your future.
Let's stick in the past. Here, I'm gonna give you more money. Just do the past reading 13 more times. I need more detail.
No, Johnny's like, just go on. Alright.
Of course. As he shuffles the cards once more, he kind of like... And he says, "Alright, now, think to your present. What is happening in your life? What is most important to you right now?"
He looks a little distracted, but just nods his head.
All right. He puts down the card, and you see the card, the Fool. And it kind of gives like a like a little bit of a
way to tell me to go fuck myself cards, huh?
And he says, huh, it seems that you've had a new beginning recently. Major disturbance in your life has caused you to reevaluate certain things. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Well, sir, have you had anything sort of... I assume you've probably had some sort of large changes in your life.
What's the last one?
The last one, of course, sir, of course. Now, I want you to try to peer into your future. See as far ahead as you can. As he just shuffles the cards once more. Now, do you have an image of the future in your mind?
Yeah.
Very well. And you can see he... he kind of like throws the cards in the air once more, closes his eyes, and then reaches out towards one, but doesn't grab it, just points at it, and it just hangs in air, and then he kind of like gestures it for it to hit the table. And turned against you, you see the card, the world.
The world.
The world.
El mundo.
Jeez. And he looks at it and he goes, I see. Forces greater than yourself seem to gather around you. Though I don't know if they are here to help you or to hurt you. Whether you are to embrace it or reject it. But something great has its eyes set on you, whether it be destiny or some other force. Do be careful.
Alright. Donnie's gonna like lean in. What do you see in the first one? I'm more curious about the first one. See, I didn't know that.
Didn't know that.
So part of me's half me's thinking you're pulling my leg, half me's thinking you actually got something. No offense.
Oh, none taken. There are plenty of charlatans who use these cards merely to gather coin for themselves. No. You can rest assured that while I may not understand the entirety of your circumstances, from what I can read, you had a great love in your past, whether someone had let you know it or not. Perhaps, since you seem as confused, I would gather you probably had a lover of, like, a admirer of sorts who never quite confessed their feelings, but certainly care for you deeply.
Can I roll a history check? Is this dredging up anything?
No.
Damn. All right.
Donnie, you search your mind and just nothing's coming back up.
Damn, that's relatable.
Well then. I hope that was enlightening for you two. Would anyone else like to take a crack at this?
Bear, you gotta try this. It's so much fun.
I dropped my phone on my face.
Oh no. Are you alright?
I'm good.
What about you? Vera, they said your name was. Did you want to take a crack at this?
Yes, please.
Alright, sit on down, Vera. And we'll get to yours in just a moment. We're going to switch back over to Eric. Because he's got a thing, and then we'll get back to you, and then we can probably move on from this. Sound good?
Nice.
Alright.
Yeah, how much does it cost to put beers in an icebox?
Alright, you walk up to this door war. He's kind of like sitting on a chair, leaning back. You do see this door war has like two rapiers at his side. And he kind of like looks up and he goes, "Hey, what can I do for you?"
Put the icebox down, open it up towards him. Alcohol here. Of course, I'll pay you for it. I'm just, hey.
pause and goes, I'm sorry, you cut out there for me. What'd you say?
I'd like alcohol here, and I'll point towards the icebox. How much do you want?
It depends. Are you looking for beer, wine, rum, tequila, bourbon, whiskey?
I think one bottle of rum, because, you know, beach, haha. Then the rest, right. Beer.
Alright.
Can I, do spending real quick to...
Yes, Vera, what do you want? You're all the way over there. I can see the old face you're making when he starts holding beer cans. It's like, yes.
Can you get wine for sangria?
Okay, yeah, we'll do wine. Okay. Do you have any, like, weird fizzy drinks?
Couple of things you can use as mixers. You said you're looking for sangria?
That's what they asked for. I don't know what it is, but...
It's kind of like a wine, tequila, fruit juice sort of thing.
Got it. Perfect.
Alright, well, I can sell you stuff for that if you want, but you're gonna have to make it yourself.
Trust me, I have more than enough utensils to do any making that's necessary.
Alright, sounds good on me. Let me take a look here and see. Kind of like starts going back. How nice are you looking for? Are you looking for good stuff, or are you looking for just something to keep yourselves entertained?
Good stuff.
Alright,
but not like 50-year-old vintage good stuff, like good stuff as in that's a good wine.
I gotcha. As he kind of like goes to the back, and you can see him just start to come back with a crate full of stuff. He's like, alright, got you a nice bottle of rum, here's some good red wine for your sangria. I got you also white in case y'all looking for something a little lighter. Tequila, beer, and a whole ton of mixers.
Okay.
Fruit juice, simple syrup, that sort of thing.
Do you have disposable cups and maybe a Sharpie?
No. You're probably gonna have to talk to the fellow across... Where is he?
He's going to procure another icebox for all the food.
Right.
Procure, yes.
Yes, anyway. Alright, so all this is gonna cost you a good bit. We're gonna be looking around 30 gold.
Done. Here you go.
This part of town. Alright, anything else I can do for you?
No, I think I'm okay. I'm gonna go back over there, get disposable cups in the icebox, then I'm gonna go find a good place on the beach to start.
If you're looking for a good place on the beach, I recommend keep going down this way. You're gonna see a grass trail that keeps going down. Actually, take a left when you see a sign that says onto Hokuluku Beach. You're gonna take a left, and then you're gonna see a little ways off that another smaller trail that's not quite as obvious. Go down that way a bit, and you'll find a nice little spot.
Got it. Thank you very much, sir. Here.
Of course.
And I'll give him an extra 2 gold, because I know he overcharged me, but I want to make sure he knows his knowledge is valuable to me.
Thank you, sir. Actually, Bellis, roll me an intelligence check.
I don't want to do that. I'm trying to drink.
The whole fun of drinking is to stop these. And it shows.
See, look, a 13. So it's fine.
With 13, you kind of look down at the supplies. You actually got a fair price for all this stuff. He did not like oversell you on a lot, like on anything here.
Oh my!
Well, you paid like 30 gold.
I took out half his stock, so maybe that helped. But yeah, I get it.
As you kind of like get that stuff like start putting away, eventually, you see the little crazy guy come back with a cooler.
I give him
over
2 gold immediately, and so he can just toss me the ice box. So he can get out of his hands as quick as possible.
Yeah, you throw the 2 gold. He's like, here! And he just throws it at your feet. He's like, thank you! And he just like...
Another gold. Get some solo cups and a marker.
Got it! And he just runs back over to his shop. Throws it back open. It just dives back in over the counter. Hey! And he just like... he doesn't bother getting out of the counter. He just like throws it at you.
Alright. Well, that's not suspicious. I'll be at the beach, guys. And I'll tell them the directions I got, and then start heading over so I can start setting up the grill and everything.
Alright. Alright, Farinata, we're gonna go back to you now.
Woo!
So you come up to this gentleman who is, the red hair bandana holding the cards. He's kind of like... And as you kind of like sit down in front of him and says, "Lovely to meet you. I think they said your name was Veronata."
Yes. That's true. Vera, you can just say Vera.
Vera. Pleasure to meet you, Vera. So, as you've seen from your other friends, you ready to get this started?
Absolutely.
All right. As he puts the cards down, he says, "All right. Now, I want you to think hard on this. What's your past? Most defining moment."
Oh, do you want me to say it out loud?
No. You think it.
Okay, I'm thinking it.
Alright. And as he puts the card down, he reveals the Empress.
Oh.
I see you had a bit of a fling with... You had a little, preview of power, it seems. Something, sometime in your past you had something, someone who was a bit more connected, maybe?
Yeah.
Alright, interesting. Alright. What about your present? Think of your present. You ready? You thinking on it?
Oh, okay, yeah.
Alright. He throws down another card, and it is the Wheel. And it kind of goes, "Huh. Well, young Veronata, it seems that you got, how should I say, something's tugging you along. From what I can tell, you're not necessarily always the one making the important decisions. Sounds like, to me, from what the cards are telling me, that you tend to just kind of drift along. You're more of a passive viewer than a real active player, yeah?"
Oh, true.
"Is that something you're looking to change?"
Maybe.
Maybe? Well, you see, there's that passiveness again. You're not committing.
Okay. Then, yes. I would say so.
Alright. Let's see what your future got there. And he kind of shuffles cards once more and puts down another one in front of you. And it is the card, the Sun. And goes, look at that. Your radiance is shining forth finally. Seems like in the future you've probably put something in your past behind you and made yourself a bit more of a brighter figure. A bit more attention around. Less passive.
I see.
Anything else I gonna? And he looks at you and he's like, "Alright, that's what I see." Oh, and that'll be 2 gold, of course.
Oh, of course.
Alright, you hand him 2 gold?
Yes.
Alright.
That's nice. I got a little to think about now.
Yeah, don't worry about it, Vera. Just make sure that you be a little more assertive. That's all you got. I'm sure things will work out for you that way.
Yeah. We can hope.
Alright, as you kind of finish up the card reading, it says, "Alright, well, it looks like your friend's heading on off without you. You all better catch up. Winchester, this is about the time you finish up with the gift."
Sounds good.
Odub walks over to y'all, too. "Hey guys! Winchester bought stuff."
Cool. Indeed. he says, takes out a little bit, taps into his pipe.
Oh, you're starting already?
He's getting his pipe out.
Donnie, so the lovers, huh?
Is there anyone you want to tell me about?
I just forgot he left. He went to get to care of
Donnie anyway. Is disassociating both in real life.
Yeah, Donnie's just going like Vietnam stare out.
Anyways, did you all enjoy your visit to the fair?
It was good.
Yeah, it was great. Very entertaining, to say the least.
Yeah, you learned anything interesting?
Why don't you tell him, Donnie?
Donnie's just staring at the ground.
My word, you look like you could use a hit of this. Little hand Donnie.
This is gonna be so sad. Can Donnie roll an insight check on Lucius?
Alright.
For one reason.
What are you trying to insight, friend?
Is Lucius mad at him?
No.
For some fucking
buddy.
Reason.
Lucius, what's
That's his first thought.
Lucius, what's he writing on you right now? I assume a 14 wouldn't beat your passive deception. Well, what's your passive deception?
Deception?
15? I mean, what's their charisma score?
What's your deception? What is your deception score? What's your deception modifier?
Let me check.
Just add 10 to it, and that's your passive score.
Okay.
I mean,
15.
Yeah, he does it.
All right, Lucius. You can tell him anything you want. Does not have to be the truth.
Okay. You can tell.
Damn. Alright. Gonna be one of those. Okay. Fair enough.
Would you like some of this, good sir? He kind of hands Donnie his pipe. Looks like you could use to take the edge off, honestly. You seem a bit tense.
I'm good.
Can I get a hit of that?
Of course.
Okay, thank you. Since when did you smoke tobacco?
Are you asking Winchester or are you asking Maggie? Alright, well, you're not
Vera, yeah.
Sure. It was probably 50 years ago.
That's a little bit before you met me. Then I guess that's fine. Yeah. I'm not gonna get in your way.
I'm
having
lightly.
Fun. I'm sorry that I did it the first time. I meant well.
I like the idea that this gift strength pot too he's handing over.
Oh my god. Loudest shit in the crystal sphere right here.
That's what you call. Like taking a shot of elephant tranquilizer.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, this is designed for a 1,000-pound creature.
I'll tank it.
Just you take a hit?
Yeah.
Alright, Baronata. I assume you're not you don't have access to your sheet, so I'm gonna have to say roll a con save.
Okay, killer. I literally can't.
Yeah, okay, I'll do it for you. No worries.
And that one!
Okay, no, never let Michael roll on my sheet ever.
Oh, come on, that's priceless.
Are you sure you handle a sangria? Just like, what, like, you know, a half cup.
All of a sudden, Marinata can taste colors.
Marinata, you're like
I'm still gonna have sangria.
Hold on. So, Marinata. You are really considering what this Terror Rio just told you, and it's like, man, maybe I am a bit too passive. And as you kind of like just huff on Winchester's pipe, you go, you don't notice at first, and then you're like, and then a couple seconds later, it's like, oh.
It's only been 50 years. Oh god, 50 years.
Use Sir coughing up a good bit, and you're like, oh!
My word, are you alright?
That's strong! That's really strong!
You sound like a man!
That's crazy.
No offense.
I did not mean to that. But that shit's good though, low key.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Only the best from other gift suppliers.
You're like, Maggie, it's gonna take a minute or two before it hits you, but we'll get to that in a bit. You're fine for now, but we'll get to that in a minute.
He also hand the pipe to O-Dub, because I'm assuming he's been eyeing him.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Well, I don't know about handing it to O-Dub now. That's a bit much.
O-Dub looks at you, Lucius, and goes, Lucius, I've smoked more than you've been. I've been smoking way stronger stuff than you have ever had a chance to get.
Yeah.
I don't really smoke.
I started a forest fire once. That counts.
They used to call me Smokey the Penguin.
Then I spent 10 years preventing forest fires because I smoked too much.
I'm just going to put my hands up defensively. It's like, you know what? I was just trying to be helpful and give you word of caution. You do what you want to do.
O-Dub appreciate, but O-Dub know what O-Dub doing. Okay. And O-Dub will take a big puff and we'll see how this goes for him. Hold on. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna rule this public. Here we go. Let me see here. Whisper talk. There we go. Alright, you guys ready?
Yeah.
O-Dub hits it. Gets a good puff, blows it out, and goes, not bad. It's good. Hands it back to Winchester.
Indeed.
Fucking shit out of me.
Odo goes, Lucius, you try. Good time. Good flavor.
What? Me? I don't know.
Oh, come on, Luther. How often do you go on vacation?
Never.
Well, there you go, then. It's only the experience the beach.
Fine, I'll just do one hit, and that's it.
You're very good. The medicinal and all that.
Good time.
I don't see how tobacco could be medicinal, but alright.
Oh, good time. Very good medicine and some smoking tobacco. Yeah, good time. Lucius, do you take a hit?
You tried.
Oh god.
All right.
It's not tobacco at all. Yeah.
And Lucius, you get a hit of it and it like hits your lungs and you're like, oh, I made a horrible error, and just start coughing up a lung.
The minute he starts coughing, Dottie gets out of whatever thousand yard stare he's in. It's like, oh my god, are you right?
It's tobacco!
I never said it was! Winchester just starts puffing his pipe.
I think you were the one who was assuming it was tobacco the entire time.
Yes, those were the ashes of a treant. Anyway.
The air is so spicy.
Also, Winchester, for sakes of shits and giggles, since you're also puffing on this, roll me a constitution saving throw. I'll say you have advantage.
I got a 21. I'm good. Me and O-Dub are just fucking like old, like fucking hardcore tweaker tokers candidate back and forth. No worries.
You guys are getting a nice buzz going on. Like, you guys are feeling good. We'll get to Lucius and Verinata in a bit. Alright. And as you guys are kind of like going, oh man, hurt, and Winchester and O-Dub are just kind of like, yeah, what up? Well, you okay? You guys are free to continue on your way.
Are we just gonna head to where Ballas is?
Probably.
Okay, kill her.
Gonna make sure fucking Lucius is okay and not actively dying from hitting it too hard.
Yeah, so about that, as you guys continue walking forward, as you're kind of like keeping an eye on like Lucius and Veronata, you guys kind of just start like walking the trail, and like Veronata, Lucius, like you start to feel like the sand in between your toes, and it's like it's kind of weird feeling, but it's kind of like nice as you kind of like wiggle your toes, and it's like, huh, that's weird. That's kind of nice. And like you kind of like you're walking by some tall grass, and you kind of like hold your hand out to feel, and it's like, yo, that's like kind of soft. Like I like that. And you and like Donnie, as you're looking at Lucius, pupils very dilated, and his eyes are—they're getting pretty, pretty red.
He picked up some blades of glasses, and now, blades of grass are now rubbing against his face, which is slightly concerning.
He's gonna look at it like, "Are you sure you're all right?"
I'm great.
He says he's great, and Lucius, you feel great. Like, man, this is nice.
This is why he got the chill stuff. If he got the rage shit, we would have a whole different conversation right now.
We'd be rolling initiative.
Yeah.
Probably.
Just turns the fuck but... in, Donnie. Where was he? Who did you fight before? Just...
Yeah, man. No, this shit's like, oh, fuck. Like, the sand is so fucking, like, soft here. Like, fuck!
I am going to slowly move over to some spot and help Lucius sit down.
No, I'm if on he's with. If...
But, nah, man, he wants to explore. He wants to explore.
Are you trying to, like, coax me into it as well by getting contact high by these people just puffing in my presence? Is this
no,
what we're going for?
No, you're good, man. You're good. Fuck, I could actually pull out my pipe and actually start smoking and give you a better description of what's going on.
You're DMing, I wouldn't.
Ah, yeah, I'm DMing, I wouldn't. But, but hey, we're gonna get back to Ballast for a moment. Ballast! As you're kind of like walking down along, you find kind of the spot the door where I was telling you about, and you do actually kind of like see a bit of smoke towards that direction as you kind of get over there. You do see a man. And he is actually starting a fire there. Looks like he's got his own sort of like camp supplies. I will DM you what he looks like, because I want that to be a surprise in a moment for the rest of you.
Oh.
But yeah, Veronata, you are also fucking high as shit, and Odub just kind of like taps you on the side and goes, "You good?"
I'm fine. I'm good. Yeah.
By the way, Eric, that is what you see. That's the man you see, and he kind of looks over.
At first I was just like, well, someone else is here, so I don't want to be here. But then I saw the guy, and I'm like, well, I have to be here now.
Yeah.
And so yeah. I plan on not necessarily interacting him, but off to the side, slightly over to the right. Set up a small grill, set up the parasol, undo the armor, get into the trunks, all that fun stuff. Put on the sunscreen because I need to make sure I don't fucking blow up. Like, literally just have, hey, we're having a beach thing here. Here you go, all the shade and everything.
Yep. He looks over to you as you start doing that. He's like, hello, man. Hello, sir. How are you? Setting up for a party?
Yep, the rest of my adventuring companions, we're on vacation, they're on their way. It's another five of them or so.
Oh. That's very nice. Nice little spot out here.
Yeah, the I think Dalen, or the guy who sold me the liquor, he told me this is a good spot.
Dalen. Well, no, it's a good spot. I was actually out here just about to make myself a nice little roast. You want some?
Well, sure, why not?
Yeah.
And when I finish the crawfish, I'll get you some too.
Yeah, thanks, man. And yeah, you guys go cooking about your business. The rest of you are eventually finally get a chance to catch up.
Michael, I would like to say Winchester if you could see by a quick glance to find a person selling coconuts.
You know, I'll say yes. You do find some coconuts.
He would very much like to buy coconuts.
How many coconuts do you want?
He'll get 6, one for everybody.
Alright, we'll say just a silver.
Okay, can I get watermelon and a baseball bat?
Why do you need a baseball bat?
You never heard of smashing the watermelons, Michael?
No.
It's like classic
It's like pinata,
activity.
But on the beach.
Yeah.
I'll say sure, you can get that stuff.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. You find yourself a nice club and a watermelon. Sure, we'll go with that. You guys get that stuff ready, start getting your way down, following the instructions. Donnie, it's weird. It's kind of weird, you're the only sober one here. Like, Winchester and Odub are holding their shit together pretty well, but they're a bit relaxed.
They're that good high.
Yeah, they got that good high. You can actually see Winchester occasionally reaching into his, bag for some rations as he's just kind of marching along the trail.
See a big bag of pretzels he bought just fucking hanging off the side where he usually puts his bullets.
Yeah. And eventually you guys all make your way over to this nice beach. Ballas, if you can just set yourself over here somewhere. And then the rest of you can put yourselves over here.
Who the
f
is that?
Hold on. And as you guys kind of approach, you see Ballas hanging out with this guy.
Oh no!
Why is there just a Jack Leone in here?
Why do you think Maggie was necessary for the beach episode?
Where did we set up again?
Oh, I love the fact that she's high as fuck right now, so no filter!
Oh no, he's hot!
Did you say that?
Oh no!
Yeah. You also see Ballast out of his, like, armor, for once, which is kind of weird.
But still has his helmet on, which is just fantastic.
Actually, the helmet is off, too. I'm using it for the crab oil.
That's gonna smell amazing later.
No, it's... yeah, it'll be fine.
But yeah, let me put on Veronata and Odub over there. But yeah, you all see Ballast kind of cooking with this Leonin.
Oh, hi everyone. I set up all of our chairs and blankets over here if you need to take a break. The beers are cool. So is some ingredients for sangria. Enjoy.
Oh,
also, this is someone who's going to be sharing the beach with us.
Oh, yeah, good day, Tha. And Winchester will walk up to him to shake his hand.
Nice to meet you. The name's, the name's Karim.
Oh, no, pleasure to meet you, Karim. Winchester hit potties.
Nice to meet you, Winchester. Who are your friends over there?
Oh, he's
And Winchester, as you turn around to look back, you see everyone standing there. Veronata is, as you would imagine her, and then Lucius has just wandered towards the water's edge.
Dottie's very quickly trying to catch up, like, wait.
Lucius, as the waves hit your feet, they're kind of like cold. Yeah. It's like such a refreshing cold, you know? Like, oh my god, that's amazing. And just like the way the water like goes over your feet and like back and like pulls against you, it's like, ha, fuck, that's amazing. Fuck, that's nice.
Yeah, Winchester looks back over his shoulder, looks back, yeah, they'll be back in a minute. Honestly, they can't hold the hubbage.
Verona, what are you doing right now? I'm very curious to what you're doing specifically.
This feels really targeted.
You think?
That's
it. Yeah.
100%
it is. I'm here to make the astute observations, okay?
I can't. No wonder you were fucking asking so many questions yesterday.
God, the worst part is, man, do you know what fur feels like when you're high? Man, that is just...
No.
Fair enough, what are you doing?
Vera's gonna be the most nervous she's ever been in her entire life right now.
Alright. As he looks over...
100 years of whatever out the window.
Winchester looks behind him and just looks back at him and goes, "Oh, there's my friend, Vianata. Quite a lovely lass. A bard, in fact. Beautiful thing, in fact."
Oh, music pick.
Indeed.
Yeah, like one of those.
That is my main chap. Odub. Winchester does like the fucking like fist pump out.
Odub just kind of like repeats the gesture with the little finger.
And over there is Donnie and Lucius. Lucius is the one right now standing in the water, while Donnie is the one panicking, apparently.
He kind of looks at you all and he's like, "I see you guys have been probably smoking some grass."
Oh, of course. Would you like them?
Maybe in a bit.
Of course, of course. He's just still puffing his pipe.
Rather get this roast finished first.
Oh, of course, of course. After all, seasoning is very important.
Yeah, no, and also help yourselves.
Oh, well, thank you very much, sir. Vianata, would you like to come over to say hi?
Sure. Yeah.
He's quite a lovely man.
Will do. I bet he is. He's very... nice.
Indeed.
As you're just standing there awkwardly, Odub just kind of like reaches up and just pushes you forward. And you just hear in your mind, Verinata, "Go make a friend."
Okay.
Go.
Dallas, do you make have friend. A sangria?
Wait, I just thought of something. I want to see.
Alright, Lucius, you start walking more and more into the water. You're probably about hip height.
I go completely under.
Alright. You go completely under the water. And you feel kind of like you're like covered in ice, but in like a good way. Like, fuck, this is weird. And then, like, "Oh, right, I just smoked a whole bunch. I'm kind of short on breath." And you stand up, and you're like... And then you just feel, like, the water just, like, dripping off your hair, your horns, and just like, "Wow. This is awesome."
Oh my god, I think I just found my happy place. This place is fucking amazing.
This is the, like, most loose we've ever seen, Lucius.
Yes,
Lucius, do you want to come back over here and go sit down with them?
You gotta get in the water. It feels so great.
Donnie just looks at the water.
It's really nice looking water.
Faust will come over with a bottle and be like, "Donnie, for their own safety, you need to get them some sunblock, or else they're gonna regret it. Okay, you need to get that done." I don't know how. It's not my job to find out. It's your job. So enjoy that.
Yeah, your job. And O double start like trying to push Verinata forward towards the lion man.
Don't forget you control them, Michael.
That's right. Verinata, are you letting Oda push you towards the lion man?
Yes.
Alright.
Like she could stop it at this point.
Yeah, fair point. He pushes you up. Donnie, you have sunscreen now for Lucius. And or yourself.
Lucius, you should probably come put his... He's looking at the water and then looking away and then looking over at Lucius to make sure he's not actively dying and then looking away and doing... He's just really nervous. It's like, You should come put this on, so you don't burn.
What? Is there seaweed in my heart? Why are you looking at me like that?
Huh?
You're being weird.
Johnny, don't forget, you'll have to get Luthish's back after all. He won't be able to reach that spot. You'll need to do it for him.
You also hear in your mind, Donnie. Yeah! Get his back! Lower back! Really hard spot to reach. And gives you a wink.
Donnie dies internally.
Ah, so he's dead on the outside as well as...
I'll say...
Death has gripped you a third time.
If that's what he calls his hands, then I guess death has gripped a lot of things.
Odom kind of wanders up to you, Ballas, and goes, need help?
Oh no, most of it's already set up. It's just one of those things, like, you gotta tend to the boil and everything.
Okay. Odom can take over if you want break.
Me and Juan aren't the best pals, I think we're fine.
Okay, well, if you want help, Odub can help.
Of course, thanks, Odub. Hey, here, and I'll give him a fishing pole. See if you can catch us some wild grub.
Fuck yeah! He just runs off to the beach.
Oh, turn around, come back.
Comes back.
Special penguin sunscreen. You can get sunburned, don't say you can't.
But Odub can...
Nope.
But, okay.
Odub?
It make Ballast happy, Odub put it on.
Yeah, it's literally, you can get sunscreen, and getting you and getting rid of your sunscreen is going to be harder than getting rid of anyone else's sunscreen. Sunburn.
Okay. And, Winchester, you just hear in your mind, I think he overprotective, but he good guy.
I'm just... I can't remember. We can respond back to him in the mind, or does it have to be out loud?
Has to be out loud.
Which just kind of looks over at Ballas and looks back and shrugs.
And then Oda will start running towards the beach again.
Ballas, I'm surprised you actually know about sunscreen being, you know, raised in the Underdark and all that.
Oh, well, I mean, we had this thing where... We had some very, very hot plants breathe up in our faces, and that would cause burns. And, yeah, it happened to birds, too. It wasn't fun.
Hey, imagine that.
Leonin, Rackham, looks at you, Verna, is like,
so I hear you're a music maker.
Yeah, I do that. It's a nice traveling gig. Do it lightly.
Okay, your friend told me you're adventurers.
Yeah.
Nice, sounds like fun.
You local?
Yeah, actually, I'm,
That's cool, that's nice.
Yeah, my people are actually some of the natives of these islands.
Oh, that's cute. A lot of roots then here.
Yeah, like, I wouldn't mind. I've done a little traveling my day. I've seen a couple different places, but, you know, I always come back here every year or so to kind of catch up with some old friends and just kind of enjoy my hometown. You know what I mean?
I haven't been to my hometown in, like, probably a couple, like a maybe 100-ish years.
Oh, that's right. I was living a long time, yeah?
Yeah. And plus Feywild, it's not the easiest place to get back to.
Yeah. I hear they have some good eatings up there, though. Like in the Feywilds.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really good. Party time life down there, was fun in my younger years, yeah.
Younger years? You practically, you don't look a day over, well, 100, I guess, for an elf? I don't... I would say 20, but...
Oh, that's your two guys.
And he kind of like looks over to the
Yeah, I'm like, I'm pushing 300. Mostly because of Ghost.
Ghost? Oh, right, adventure, yeah. I could imagine that's a thing. By the way, you cook it all or no?
This is a deafening silence.
Maggie, you there?
It cut out really bad.
Oh, okay. Are you back?
Yeah, I'm back now.
Okay, yeah, he asked you if you cook.
Not a lot. No. Oh.
Do you want to try out, do you want to try, like, learn how to do this dry rub on this, tenderloin?
Cutting out again.
No, he asked if you want to learn how to make his tenderloin that he's doing right now. He says, yeah.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, every time down.
Yeah, come here.
He's internally screaming.
He says, I'm about to put the dry rub on it if you want to help with that.
Damn. That was about to say.
Right. He takes you where he's kind of like set up, and he kind of like starts like going over what spices are used, and he's like, okay, and he kind of hands you a bowl with the spices already mixed in it. He says, you're just going to take some of this and just kind of like just rub it on the meat.
I can't take this.
What was that?
Nothing. Yeah, I'll do it. I was gonna make, yeah, I definitely wanna rub.
You know what really stinks? You're like, the person who could help with your escape is currently very high, arguing about sunblock far enough away.
Yep. And Verena, he's like, alright, well, are you gonna take the spices or?
Yeah, I'll do it. Sorry, I'm really high right now.
I can tell.
Thank you.
Kind of chuckles a bit at that.
I'm high really right now. I can tell. Oh, thank you.
You were
That's
well.
Fucking bit.
Well, that is the right response, though.
Yeah.
Varinata, you grab some of this dry rub, and it's weird. It's a weird feeling in your hands, especially right now. Like, oh, it's like grainy, but also like. You can kind of like feel each of the grains. It's so weird, but like you're like, oh right, hot lion guy next to me, and you're like, you start doing what he says, and he's like, you start like kind of like patting the tenderloin and like rubbing it a bit. And he's like, not bad, but you want to kind of get really in there, like really in there, and he's kind of like, and he kind of like reaches over his hand. He's like, may I?
Yeah, of course.
All right, and he kind of like grabs your hand and kind of like helps you like press it down. He's like, this you kind of want to. Kind of one, like, it's like showing you how to do it properly.
Damn, he could. Never mind.
And so that's happening. Lucius Donnie.
Donnie is like, we should probably go put this on so you don't burn Lucius.
No.
Not real.
Why not?
I don't want
to. Okay. And he just puts down the sunblock and just is standing there with Lucius very awkwardly. God damn it, Heath, I was just about to fucking post that. God damn it!
Exact thing, right? That's what it was. Right? Yeah, the ghost scene. just like work that in there. Just like.
Oh my god.
Lucius, you hear in your mind exclusively Odo's voice and goes, Lucius, think for a second.
Donnie rubbing a nice ointment on your body. That feel good right now.
Jesus Christ. Damn. Why is the fucking penguin doing this?
Because no one else will.
I mean, Winchester would, but he doesn't have the ability to speak directly to minds.
Man, man. Now that's what I call a wingman.
Odo's a real wingman.
Mm-hmm. You know what?
To be fair, he already had it done to him when
I'll put it on if you put it on for me.
Alright. Sure, yeah. Picks it up and is like, you should probably go find somewhere where we can do that.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, you like exploring so much, go pick a spot. Yep. Fantastic.
Just through the water. Just head in opposite direction.
Donnie, I found a spot!
In between two
yep,
rocks.
The couple's going behind the rocks. Yep. As always.
Well,
Odub looks over to you, Winchester, and just gives a thumbs up.
Winchester just kind of like tilts his glasses and gives a nod.
What Lucius doesn't know, sadly, is when he was going through that area, he accidentally got his horn stuck on the twine of the fishing pole. That's going to be very awkward in a few minutes when there's a lot of tugging.
you know what?
I woke up today. This wasn't what I expected in D&D.
It was the beach episode. What were you expecting?
I don't know, Michael. I don't come to D&D with any fucking expectations, but this wasn't it.
So, Donnie, as you and Lucius start to get behind this rock, Lucius, you're about to like take your shirt off, and then you just feel like a tug on the back of your shirt.
What?
And it just like reels. I need you to make an athletics check at disadvantage.
Oh no! Why would you do that to me?
Because it's funny.
Fair.
All right, with a 10. All right, so with a 10. You kind of like stand your ground, but you feel the tugging, and Winchester, you can see like Odub's really battling with something. He caught a big one.
Can Donnie see the hook?
Not from your angle.
Alrighty.
You just see like Lucius just kind of like step back for a second as his chest is just, like his upper body is just kind of jostling a little bit.
He's just like, what are you doing?
I think there's a crab on my shirt.
What? Why is there's what?
I was Donnie in the water.
Donnie is then going to look around. Like, all what's right. going on?
Easy enough, you can see like where his shirt's being pulled. There's a hook in there.
Donnie just like reaches behind Lucius and unhooks it.
Alright. As you unhook it, do you let it go?
Yes.
Alright, you let it go. The rest of you see Odub just, like, pulling with all his might and then, flunk, as he just kind of, like, falls backwards.
Oh no.
Into the sand. looks at his pole and just sees there's nothing on the other end of the line and just looks defeated.
That's so sad. Anyways.
Back to you two.
Donnie nice. Just looks at Lucius like, is this a spot?
I don't know. Is this good?
That's your decision.
Then yes.
Alright. Donnie just kind of stands there awkwardly.
Where's the sunscreen?
In my hand. I was waiting.
Oh, my bad. I'm gonna take off my shirt.
Donnie, Lucius takes off his shirt in front of you and you see his full twink form.
No.
Blinding light of twink.
Lucius has evolved into twink.
God.
Yep. I was afraid too. I was like, I wanna like draw him if he doesn't seem like twinky.
Yep, yeah, Dottie just... There is no reaction. Dottie's just waiting.
I'm gonna turn around and sit down. And then you'll just see, like, cosmic designs on my back.
Oh. What's this?
What's what?
Stuff on your back.
A birthmark.
Oh.
Kind of the whole tiefling thing. But yeah, it kind of glows.
How are you?
Neat. Yeah. I've had it, like, at one time at this party that I went with Vera. People tried, like, connecting the dots. That was very wasted. I don't remember a lot.
What a coincidence.
Someone said there was, like, constellations in there.
Donnie just looks to see if there's constellations in there.
Roll me a... I'm gonna say just intelligence check.
Yeah, that's fair. How's an 11, Michael?
Only the Little Dipper.
They could be constellations of some place in the universe. Like, it depends on where you are in Wild Space, right? Like, depending on where you're at, like, constellations are completely different.
In other words, everything's a constellation when it just dots.
Yeah, like, it could be. Like, someone could see something in there.
Fair enough, Donnie. Donnie will then do what he said he was going to do and apply sunscreen to Lucius because it is needed. Huffing copium the entire time internally and panicking.
All right. Donnie, you start applying the sunscreen. Lucius, it's cold? And it's kind of, like, weird and a little, like, kind of, like, greasy, slimy, but it's, like, it's such a weird fucking feeling, but it's a nice, weird feeling. You know what I mean? It's... And just, like, Donnie's hands just kind of, like, pressing up against your skin. God, that's so fucking weird. Like, it's cold, but it's also just... Which is kind of nice on a day like this. Like, Donnie is nice to touch on a day like this.
Whoa.
Understood.
So you guys are doing that. Ballas, we're gonna move over to you for a second. Alright. I want you to make me a cook's utensil check to see how your thing is going.
What attribute?
I'm gonna let you pick.
Well, I'll choose intelligence.
Go for it.
28.
Alright, do you want to flash a genius that because you can?
Yes. So instead, it's now a... Oh, hey, my flash of genius is now... 6 charges at plus 6, so that is a solid 34.
Alright, you, over the course of like a couple hours, throw together like a 5-star restaurant sort of like feast. And everyone, even and the Lion Man, Karim, is looking at you like, oh fuck. As you just start, like, getting really into the process. His roast is also going pretty well. Not as well as you, obviously, but, like, it's going pretty damn well for
me. I got a 34. Can we say we incorporated the roast into one of the things? We'll just combine it at some point. Make it so it's contribution of everyone, and it doesn't seem like I'm showing them up.
You know what? We'll go with that.
Yes.
And Varanata, he kind of... Karim also kind of, like, invites you to also kind of, like... join them in preparing the meal.
Yeah, of course. I'll be a little assistant.
Yeah, of course. And he does pass you a glass of sangria.
Perfect. I down it heavily.
Okay.
Do me a favor. Can you make Vera roll a dexterity saving throw?
I can. This will be a disadvantage.
Okay. Looking for low.
Alright, disadvantage.
Oh, shit.
19!
Yeah. I mean, they got a high dex, yeah, if that makes sense.
No, yeah. Fair. What I was hoping for was there was a moment when they were, like, setting up the food, if their hands, like, brushed against each other, and I was like,
oh! Oh, like a trip, and I grab his arm, and I'm like, oh my gosh, you're so strong.
And so you, like, even though you, like, trip and, you know what, with the dex save, can we say you trip and grab his arm and make it seem totally accidental, but then you can do a little bit of feel, you know, you can see the bicep tray.
Yeah. So, Farinata, you kind of misstep for a moment as you kind of, like, fall and catch his arm and land into his chest a bit, and he goes, careful there, sweetie.
Oh my god, he called you sweetie. Oh my god.
It was at this moment that Varinata died.
She expired. She's done.
As you kind of are grabbing onto him and you kind of feel him, his fur, like, as like chiseled as he is, like muscular as he is, that fur, surprisingly soft.
Oh, you must have wonderful hair care. This is...
Well...
Yes.
Yeah, I do. It's, a bit of flak oil goes a long way.
How fucking mosquito in my room.
But he's like, yeah, no, like, the fur is, like, super soft to touch, but, like, underneath that fur, very strong build.
Oh my gosh. I have a watermelon and a baseball bat. Do you want to break that in? Never mind.
You want me to smash your watermelon?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
I could do that.
I'm not that strong.
Don't worry, I'm plenty strong.
Aren't we supposed to blindfold him and spin him around and...
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll set up that game. Lucius, Donnie, how is,
Lucius is not here at the moment.
Never mind. we'll pivot it over to Winchester. Winchester, are you up to anything at the moment?
You know what? Just because he would join O-Dub fishing, but Winchester does something a little silly. He'll tie his rope to his rapier and do spear fishing.
Okay. not exactly how that built. We'll see how that goes. And as you guys set up the watermelon thing...
Oh, you know what? Actually, to be fair, he does have a hand crossbow.
Okay, you're going to use that instead?
Actually, I got a magic longbow. Technically, that also... That actually is spear fishing.
I'll say that there's no funny here, though. That's just a method of fishing.
I know. I could just take my rifle and start dynamite fishing. Yeah, but Winchester will just spearfish.
Okay, as you make a makeshift spear, Odub actually gets a tug on the line. It's a pretty good pull as he started, like, pulling back. He's really fighting with the Winchester.
Would you like a hand with that, Odub?
Yeah, hand, good.
Fantastic. I just pick up him and just kind of like, you know, when the adult pulls the kid.
All right, you pick Odub up and he's like, he's too busy fighting this to be, like, even insulted at the moment. I'm going to say between the two of you, we're going to have you both make an athletics check.
I get these at advantage. Because GIF is good, because I have terrible checks on these.
Odub rolled a 17.
Ooh, I just got a 4.
Oh my god.
Alright, so you guys kind of even out to something, okay.
Wait, hold on. Did Odub roll that well?
Yeah. Holy shit. Alright, so Winchester, you kind of like pick him up and start pulling him back, and it's actually kind of really distracting for Odub. He's like, Winnie, no! Put me down! I need to focus!
Then he puts him down.
Alright, and you put him down and he's like really trying to reel it in, and eventually whoosh, a big bass lands behind him as he like pulls the fish out. And then he goes, yeah! Victory for Odub!
Jolly good.
Good job, as he pats you on the side.
I thought that was actually quite nice to the pot. Should we take it back over the bell?
Yeah! And Oda will pick up the fish and just kind of waddle run his way over to you, Ballast.
Thank you, Oda.
Yeah!
Immediately just completely skin it, defenestrate it, like everything in like 2 seconds.
Oh yeah, no, just easy, done.
Put it with some rice, sushi, there we go.
Nice. We'll go back to the lovers. What are you two up to?
Thank you, Donnie. Now turn around, let me get you.
Huh? What? What? No, no, I literally didn't hear what you said. What?
I said, thank you. Now turn around, let me get you. And you'll like squeeze some on his hand, clap them together, and start rubbing them.
Immediately starts, one sec. And then takes off his shirt and then does sits the same way he saw Lucius sitting and just go ahead.
Starts lathering that dude up. He does it.
Lathering.
But he's doing it on purpose. He's making it very sus.
How the sus on purpose?
Hi, Lucius is the best Lucius. I'm so...
still above a 10. Still above a 10. 10's the threat. 10's the breaking point, boys.
All right, Donnie, you endure Lucius just lathering your body with sunscreen. Now, Lucius, are you just getting his chest and arms and all that? You got anything else?
How handsy are you getting?
Me.
Alright, he's kind of going for the neck, kind of tilts your head towards him.
Does that feel good?
Hmm?
Does that feel good? Do you like that?
One moment.
When's the part you start rolling these at disadvantage, let's be honest?
Yeah, the next one. When we hit 5, this is number 4 he's rolled. When we hit 5, it started at disadvantage. This is how much copium he's got left in his system. I'm just, I mean, yeah, I can see why massages are a thing, I guess. I mean, we did it at one time, right?
Did you give me a massage before?
No, I didn't. You and Ballast did with me because you were looking for.
Oh, something. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. But that's all. Nothing else.
Is there an answer you're looking for?
Is there an answer you want to give me?
There it is.
Yeah, there we go!
Dottie just, like, looks down for a minute and just... I am unsure.
Only poking fun, Donnie. Relax. You get a day to breathe. Hey, relax. Nothing's trying to kill us for once.
Yeah.
So, why not enjoy it?
Donnie looks at Lucius. Just gives him a hug.
Gonna just pat his back.
And then kiss him. There you go.
There it is.
What?
Yes.
I missed it? What happened?
He kissed you.
Yeah. With the hug. Complete subversion. Fantastic. Duped. Bamboozled. Hoodwinked.
Now Lucius is just having a little favor there.
I can't hear a word you're saying.
Yeah, man, you are really hard to understand.
Oh, you have a pillow over your phone?
No, I heard the mic was under me.
Yeah, that usually helps having the microphone not underneath you when you're talking.
I'm laying down in bed, and I think I got bit by a mosquito. I'm like.
Anyways.
Lucia should make a wisdom save. It feels right.
You should.
Lucius will freeze for a moment, and then whenever they eventually separate, I don't know if it's like an instant thing or if it's like a lasting thing.
Just like the one very quick, and then the sits back and normally, and then just looks.
Damn it! I wish I wasn't high. Fuck yeah! Oh, I wanted to enjoy that sober. I had this whole thing in my head. I was gonna be like, why don't you help me sober up? Fuck. Oh man. Wow. No, that was good. That's great. More please. Seconds.
Just very internally angry, just like sitting over there pouting.
Basically.
Beautiful, right?
Yeah, I asked for seconds.
Asked for seconds!
Give that meal. Give that man a point. That was that. Yeah, cool. Donnie obliges. Absolutely. Without hesitation.
Alright, you guys are making out behind the rock.
Yep. Oh, these crazy teens.
Yup.
Lookout point.
Alright. And it's around this time you two start smelling delicious, like unresistible delicious smells coming from the other side of the rock.
I was about to say, when they come up, I'm just like, Donna, you didn't do it. Look at Lucius's face. It's all red. You need to get that sunscreen on him pronto.
I'm going to say, when they come up behind the walk, Winchester, who is in very easy hearing distance of all that and has a very high passive perception, just kind of like.
Has Donnie ever been known for fucking subtlety? I know. Right?
Winchester just kind of nods to Donnie.
Like a fucking dad.
Yeah. Good job, kid.
Now just passes him like condoms.
Yeah. Kind of like
a six pack. Like, actually, funny story about that. A friend of mine, he got condoms passed to him 3 times on his prom night. One by his dad, one by his mom, and one by his date's mom.
That's crazy.
I mean, craziest one I had was my friend who was visiting from I was living in Seven Arm and he was living on Vancouver Island. His mom gave him condoms when he came to visit me for the summer, right? We were 13! So I just looked at it, like, I went, dude, what the fuck does your mom think we're going to be doing here?
What dark secrets does she think we're going to be dark?
You know what? Can we at least congratulate on her for being so, like...
So chill.
Yeah, so chill and accepting of her son and his potential,
his potential rendezvous.
Yeah, his potential rendezvous and, you know, like, his potential preferences.
I mean, to be fair, he almost did get laid that night, that weirdly enough, so I guess his mom just had, like, a sixth sense what was happening.
But anyway, back to the game. Yeah. You guys all gather around the table, and oh my god. Ballast, if you would like to describe what you have made for everyone.
I'm not a professional. Okay, sure, fuck it. I have to lean up. Beach food. The first dish is a bit of scallions with a few pasta with a garlic aioli as a small sort of appetizer to get started. The second dish is using some of the meat given to us by our good Leonin friend with a side of red tomatoes and greens. The third dish is crawfish that has been opened but still has some of the shell on the plate for color, with a few sprigs of assorted spices and carrots. And then for dessert, We have a sherbet.
Oh my god.
And it is a delicious feast. You all sit down at the table and just begin digging in. And for those of you who have been smoking,
And or drinking. Yeah.
And it pairs well with the sangria.
Let's fucking go.
Yeah, no, this shit is good. Rackham looks at you, Varna, and is like, he's like leading, he's like, hold on, you got something. And he kind of like takes a napkin and kind of like brushes his thumb against your lips as he like kind of gets something that's there.
Oh, Varna dies for the second time tonight.
Vera, I don't think I've met your new friend here. Hi.
Hey, my name's Rackham. Yeah, I've been getting to know your friend Veronata here, but...
Oh. Well, that's good. She's quite lively, isn't she?
She's delightful in every way.
Indeed. Did you cook this tenderloin?
I did. It's kind of an old family recipe.
It's very delicious. I'd love to get your recipe sometime.
Thank you. I can see if I can maybe teach you. I was showing Veronata earlier.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she was helping me with the rubbing the spices in and helping me cook it.
Yeah, it was a good time.
I quite enjoyed her help.
What I wouldn't pay for detect thoughts right now. I don't have it.
One of you actually does, though.
Yep.
Wait, it's me.
It is you.
No, you also have it, don't you, Lucius? You have the, you took the feet, yeah?
What? Say again, I'm sorry?
I thought you had the telepathic feet.
Fuck, does anyone have Mushy?
No,
Mushy would be dead if we brought him out here.
You're right, you're fucking right.
Y'all would have cannibalized his ass so quickly.
But no, I do not have detect thoughts.
I thought you did.
No.
Okay, never mind. But he looks over to you, Varina, and is like, by the way, what you were smoking earlier?
Oh, here, right here, and Winchester hands in the pipe.
Alright, he says, thanks. And cool. He takes it and takes a puff. We'll see how he does. Okay. Over the course of the meal, his pupils dilate, which is a bit more noticeable because like he normally has like the slits in his eyes, and now they're big. And oh yeah, Veronaut, you look over, you see that? It's fucking adorable.
Oh my god.
It's like that. It looks like the Puss in Boots fucking image, doesn't it?
Yeah, kind of.
Yes. That's beautiful.
And he goes,
just this.
Exactly that, yes. And he kind of looks over at you and is like, by the way, I wanted to say, that outfit looks really good on you.
Oh, stop it, you. I play with his mane a little bit, being like, stop, you're so silly.
Billy.
You're really silly.
Stop, you're so silly.
You're silly.
No,
Oh, and he turns around on his seat to face the other direction so he can eat in peace.
It's like fucking watching parents flirt with each other. It's like, oh my god.
Relis is actively disassociating. He's like, oh yeah, I mean, you know.
Winchester is just hitting the pipe some more.
Yeah. Odub just kind of gives you grippy hands to, like, yeah, pass it over, please.
He passes the pipe over. He's like, yeah, we gotta get high for this shit.
Yep. We are not here anymore, is what we're aiming at.
Do you still have a bust in that watermelon?
Oh, yeah! Let's do that.
Yeah, let's fucking do it, man.
Of course, everyone, I'll set it up just to be safe. which just is looking at the two of them.
Yeah, Vera is now just clinging to Raku.
And he's kind of like holding on to you. Like, you two are kind of supporting each other.
Absolutely.
Curiosity, Michael, what did you roll?
For Odub?
No, for the cat.
Oh, a 9.
Oh, yeah, he's fucked.
He's like, yeah, I feel great. Alright. You guys set up the game, and Odub's like, okay, who going first?
Well, I suppose this was Vera's idea, so ladies first.
I'll go first.
And the guy goes, yeah. Yeah, show me how this goes. I haven't done this before.
Winchester takes up the blindfold, ties it around Vera's eyes.
So what would it be? What would you roll, even?
God,
Roll me a wisdom saving throw, because they're blindfolding you and spinning you around and see if you can find a watermelon to hit.
Yeah, it's more like trying to remember where you were than anything else.
Yeah. You're going to have disadvantage because you are high as fuck. Yes.
Oh my God, I can't.
Yeah, I know, I gotcha. All right, ready?
Yeah.
All right, and you're at disadvantage. Good, good. You got a 7.
Okay.
So, Paranaut, they spin you around as you're holding this club, and you're like, I think it's this way, as you just start wandering over here, and you just try to, like, smash it where you think it is, and you just kind of, like, fall forward.
Good attempt there!
And this is hilarious. As the guy goes, and he kind of like goes over, and he's like, "Okay, let me help you up." As he kind of like grabs onto your shoulders a bit, and kind of like helps you up.
Who would like to go next?
I'll go. I'll give it a try.
Of course. He brings Lucius up, ties the blindfold on him, and starts the spinning. There you go. Good luck.
Lucius, wisdom saving throw at disadvantage because you're also high as fuck.
Oh my God.
So Lucius, you kind of like wobble forward a bit, and then you kind of go to the side and kind of go back, and then you kind of like, there it is, and just swing forward and roll me just a strength based attack roll. So just roll me a strength attack.
Oh, I don't. How do I do that?
Just roll strength.
Just roll your strength because you don't have proficiency in simple weapons, probably.
No, he doesn't have. Yeah, oh, 10.
Alright, so as you go to, like, swing, Odub sees you and just ducks and goes, ah!
Did I get it?
No, I think
you almost got Odub.
I'm so sorry, Odub. Oh, please don't be mad at me. I didn't mean to. It's an accident.
It's part of the game. It's very good. It's fine. Yes.
You're good. All good. Don't cry. Please don't cry. Bring down mood.
Who would like to go next, then?
I'll go.
Very good.
Go.
Alright, Ballas. Seeing as you're not high as fuck, just roll me a wisdom saving throw flat.
I'm adding 6.
Alright. You all see as Ballas gets spun around, and it's kind of weird not seeing him in his, like, armor and his helmet and stuff like that. It's a very, like, weird seeing him, because you really associate him with the armor. But as you spin him around, he's able to kind of like keep his footing and then kind of like go forward a bit. And eventually, Ballas, you're like, okay, should be about 3 steps in front of me. And psh, roll me an attack roll.
Strength-based.
Yeah, strength-based attack roll.
See if I have anything based around that. No, okay. So we're just going to add 3 to this.
Alright, you hit the watermelon and psh, yeah, and it just like splatters everywhere.
That's great, that's beautiful.
Good job.
Yeah. Thank you.
Rackham is just like clapping his hands, going like, yeah, it looked like fun. And Odom's going, good job! You're good at this, Ballast!
Yeah, it was easy to cheat because all I did was dig where the watermelon was when I got spun. And I'll point to where I dig in the sand for the point of reference.
Ow. Zell, good job!
Thank you.
Beautiful work. Now for watermelon, the best fruit.
Oh, fuck yeah. And you guys have some watermelon to kind of like polish off your feast with. Lucius, everyone, how are you enjoying the watermelon?
Fucking delicious.
Amazing.
I mean, everybody, most of us are high as fuck, so, you know.
Yeah, no, it really, for those of you who are high, it's fucking amazing.
Immaculately. Well,
how long does this high last?
Hours, probably.
Yeah. You're in it for the long haul. And as you guys kind of like, as the sun is beginning to set, as you, Verena, you look over to Rackham and you can kind of see like some watermelon kind of like hanging off, kind of like getting like a little bit of watermelon is like hanging off his lip a little bit.
Yeah,
and he doesn't seem to notice.
Yeah, I'll wipe it off for him and then be like, do you want to go for a walk?
And he looks at you and goes, yeah.
Yeah, let's take a nice gentle stroll.
Yeah, I got my I got a private like little cabin not too far from here.
What? That's crazy.
I know, right?
Give me one second though.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna go to Lucius real quick.
Alright, you go over to Lucius.
Lucius, I'm gonna be real for you. I'm gonna be real honest with you right now.
What is it? Is there something in my hair?
No, you look great. Do not wait up for me.
Why? Where are you going?
I'm gonna be busy for the rest of the night. I'm sorry.
I'm gonna get some pussy.
You get 2 points for that one.
Oh. Have fun. Wish me good luck too.
Will do. Tell me how it goes later.
Bye.
I've been sitting here with my head in my hands this entire fucking time.
Everyone else is having a great time. Fucking Donnie is just going, fuck, and just questioning every decision that is brought here.
He's just like, did I do that? Did I actually? What the fuck?
Steve Urkel, did I?
You know what? I'm just gonna have Winchester make an insight check here on Donnie.
Go for it!
I'll add a D8 to that because I'm allowed to. 19!
You asshole! My path of deception is 17.
Yes! I love this class that I'm allowed to fucking use it on my insight.
Okay, what are you trying to insight?
Just kind of get, like, Donnie's general feel with it, like... Well, it's like a case, like, he knows him and Lucius were doing some stuff behind the rock. He had his hippo ear listening. He's just gotta gather a feeling of whether or not how his mood's going with that.
It's generally positive. He's just very contemplative. He's just deep in thought.
Winchester's just gonna kind of scoot over next to Donnie then. So Donnie, you look like you're having quite the introspective moment.
Yeah?
I just wanted to give you some advice if you're willing to take some at this point.
Just looks at you.
But take it from an old soldier. Life is short sometimes and fleeting. Take your opportunities when you get them. You know, go for the gusto. Enjoy it while you can. K- gives him a bit. Spell. Then he just like pulls his takes his sunglasses and puts them down and just gives him a wink.
There you go. Yep. I would say like Donnie. That's why I rolled inside. Would Donnie get exactly what you're getting at with that? Probably not.
Even with the wink.
No, the wink does it. Yeah, the wink.
Alright. Winchester kind of gets up. Yeah, kind of gets up and stretches and pats him. Go get him, lad.
Alright. As you are all still convened here, Phallus, are you doing anything at the moment?
I'm just letting everyone enjoy their beach day. I'm happy.
Alright. Phallus is happy?
Wow.
Yeah, I'm out in the sun. I go to my friends. I'm not physically in pain. It's good.
Nice. Nice.
He's not with his ex with a whip. He's happy.
Honestly, yeah. I get to see a seashore that ends beyond a horizon, which is a new sight. It's very relaxing.
Yeah. There's no murderous killer cave fish in it willing to eat him at any moment.
Mm-hmm. Me being without armor doesn't mean I'm going to be attacked and enslaved.
Good. God, the Underdark sucks.
Ballast, it's a good feeling, and for the first time in many years, you actually have a sense of peace about you.
Ballast does something that he hasn't done in quite a while, and sleep while other people are awake. It's crazy.
As you kind of like lay back in the sand, you drift off, and knowing that you are not in danger for once. It's a good feeling. And as you guys are all just kind of sitting enjoying the sunset, Rackham comes up to you, Verna, and is like, you wanna get going?
Yeah, I'm down.
Alright, hey, nice meeting y'all, if I don't see you later. Y'all are cool. We should hang out again. If you're ever back in the neighborhood, see if you can find me. I'm not always here, but...
I'm sure we can send you a fending or something.
Oh, right. You're adventurers. You got, like, magic and shit. That's nice.
Oh, I'm quite sure Veonata there would be more than happy to toss you a line when we return.
Oh, he looks at you and is like, please, at any point, feel free to call me.
Yeah, of course.
I would love...
Guys, I'm just gonna let him know, you know.
I'm always happy to hear a voice as lovely as yours.
Oh my gosh, stop.
Miles.
We should get going now.
Yeah, yeah. And he kind of like offers his arm to you.
Yeah, I take it.
Alright, well, I'll catch you guys later.
Of course.
Have fun.
You too. And he starts leading you away, Veronata.
Let's fucking go.
You know, I know you're not going this route, man, but this would be just the most amazing point where you just find out this is a serial murderer story.
I turn this breach episode into a murder mystery.
That's great. Gonna make my new character.
Yeah.
You were enjoying Veronata, right?
As you're wandering off with a literal lion, right? Nothing could go wrong!
Nah, you're fine. Alright, and so you two start heading down the beach into the sunset.
Great times. Great.
Alright, and as they wander off, five of you remain. Ballast is kind of napping in the sand. What are the rest of you doing?
Am I still high? Am I still out of my mind right now?
You're still pretty up there right now.
Okay.
You sleep this one off, man. Oh. You failed pretty fucking bad.
You did get an addy.
Does Lucius have lesser restoration, and does Lucius have the forethought to use lesser restoration?
I don't have restoration.
Damn.
Well, you're fucked.
Well, buddy, you're riding this one to the end.
I know.
I will just say Winchester looks over at Donnie and kind of gives him the head nod towards Lucius.
Oh, before I got high, they had a dance thing, if y'all wanted to go to that. I don't know if there's gonna be, like, drinks or, like, music. It sounds like it would be fun.
Sure.
I don't have to tear.
We can go find it, yeah, sure.
We're gonna say it is starting to get a bit later, so we're gonna start, wrapping things down, so we're gonna start speeding past some of the stuff. You guys go out to one of these traditional dances, and it is a wonderful time. Really nice, really, like, it's kind of, like, amazing. You actually, like, you had kind of, like, the nice, calm, like, sort of, like, hula dancer sort of thing, but eventually they bring out, like, the fire dancers, and you're like, whoa! Which is really freaking cool. And eventually, Lucius, and you all start to head out for the night. We're gonna say, Lucius, Donnie, we're gonna go specifically to you two. What are you doing right now?
Is this after the dance?
This is after the dance. You guys are kind of winding down.
Donnie, you wanna take a walk along the shoreline with me?
Sure.
Alright, and as you do, hold on, I gotta find the right music for this. Where was it?
Fucking god.
Give me a second.
No. I had it. No.
What?
I'm watching with deep anticipation.
I'm trying to find the right song. I know I have it here somewhere.
Be the song I want.
So help me God, Michael, if it's what I think it is.
What do you think it is?
I'm not telling you. Play it now, and I'll confirm or deny it.
I probably don't have the right one.
I mean, the odds of it are pretty astronomical if you think about it.
I think this is the one I was looking for. There you go.
I thought you were going to play fucking Careless Whisper.
I wish I had it. I honestly thought about it.
Like,
I was going to be like, can you feel the love tonight?
But anyway, you have a nice romantic track. Go!
So, I would have hoped to have this conversation a little more clear-minded. It's right now, I'm trying really hard to focus on you, but I can really feel the sand in between my toes.
You want to, like, sit down with sitting down and help you focus?
No, I'm fine walking.
Alright.
And just to let you guys, to help set the scene, you guys are kind of walking by a beach at night. Lights in the distance, and as you kind of like are continuously walking along and having this conversation, to your right, towards the ocean, you see this sort of like light blue glow coming from the water as bioluminescent fish, algae, and whatnot are lighting up the ocean in front of you.
It's really beautiful here, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's been kind of making me think.
Alright.
After everything is said and done, what is it that you want to do?
I don't really know. Because it's before... Donnie looks down, they're holding hands, obviously, yeah. It's part of the fucking scene.
So yeah.
before this, I really didn't have any goals in mind, I was just sort of going along with everyone. I mean, what are you planning on doing?
And I'm looking for my little brother still. I don't know if you recall, I spoke with him earlier, Adamite.
Oh!
But, I guess that leads to my other question, because I was going to ask if you wanted to come with me.
Sure. Yeah.
Now, you want to come with me as, you know, a traveling companion, or...
For the first time this entire day, you see Donnie cock that signature shit-eating grin and just saying, really?
Well, you know what I meant. We've never really, like, put a title on this. We're just kind of, like, gone with the flow, like how you said.
Yeah, I mean, we don't need a title for it if we don't want to.
I was just curious about your thoughts, because, I mean, I've said mine. Yours has just always been assumed, I suppose.
I didn't hear the last words, few words you said.
Your thoughts? I've always said mine. Yours, you haven't really said it outright. I've always just assumed with your gestures. But I'd like to hear it from you.
Before this journey, the 2 weeks that it was before I met you guys and started this journey, I didn't really have any indication as to what to do. I was granted, apparently, a second chance at life or whatever I am now, with no memories of what happened before. Complete blank slate. I was content to see what happened, but he turns fully, puts his hand, both hands clasping yours. I think I found what I'd like to do with the rest of my time. And that would be with you. Travel with you. Go places. I mean, you seem to know so much more about wild space than I do, and it's, whilst dangerous and frankly annoying and stuff at times, I mean, it's beautiful. You look up there into the stars and I see endless possibilities. And I didn't before you. I just saw a bunch of light. Thank you.
I don't know if I've really done anything worth a thank you yet.
You've done a lot. Trust me, you've done a lot.
Well, then I'm happy. You're still pretty vague.
I love you. And I will for as long as... I was just about to say for as long as I breathe, but I don't do that normally, do I? As long as I'm within my own faculties. Is that fair?
Yeah.
Smiles.
I feel the same. Towards you, of course. Hope you'll bear with me. I'm doing my best. I'm not really well versed in these kinds of things. The last time I really tried, one of the reasons why I'm kind of asking for validation now. Nothing was really set in stone. And it was just my own delusion. And I ended up getting really hurt. And I love you. And I don't want to get hurt like that again. So a part of me is afraid.
I would never. Listen, I'm not experienced in this stuff as well, regardless of what any fucking fortune teller says. I have literally no memory of any of this. This is all new. But wherever this leads, I'll be there. Wherever.
And I with you.
I am going to use one of my warlock invocations that I switched out to very quietly cast Silent Image and have like a bunch of little dancing stars and little streaks of starlight going between them.
Oh, I can do that. Hold on.
Damn, just get damn fucking worried.
Oh wait, no, I'm sorry, you can do that. I don't mean to steal your thunder.
What a high statement that was.
Yep. No, it's I don't know. I mean, I have some ideas. Like, I want to looks down at his own chest, like, I mean, figure out what's going on with Arlen, and maybe try and find something, I don't know, find something new to try it with you. Maybe, I mean, I don't even really know. There's so much stuff out there, who knows what I could really learn or do, but
so like you said, the possibilities are endless. I'm sure we could find something. Whether it be a solution, a way to cope, or anything really.
I mean, there's some, I know there's stuff like this on Toril, but there's like some, maybe paladin orders, clerical orders, maybe could talk to them, explain my condition. Ones that are willing, but like, I would not want to walk into a temple of Kalimdor, I tell you what. I don't think very much like me. But I mean, other places, maybe learn from them a bit more about what I am and what Arlen is, although I doubt they'll know what he is. Do you want to head back to the ship?
Yeah, we can. I'm enjoying our time together. I'd hate for it to end.
But you just want to stay out here, then?
Happy anywhere, as long as I'm with you.
Ani just looks at Lucian.
Can enjoy the moonlight a little longer. You can sit down.
Alrighty.
Maybe kiss some more.
Damn. I, Lucius, is a fucking baller.
I know. I'm so glad I bought the pot.
I was gonna ask you about that. You are, like, obviously, after all that fucking talk, this seems like a dumb question. You're good with that, right? That kind of came out of nowhere.
Good with what?
Good with what?
Yes, that answers that question.
No, ask me the question again. I'm sorry, I'm trying.
No, you're fine. You're fine. Kiss it. That was just something that came out of nowhere. Kind of pounced on you. I'm gonna be honest. Seconds? Dottie just looks at Lucian. Can I have seconds?
I was just trying to be polite.
No, honestly, it took a lot. It took, no offense, it took a lot to keep my composure. It was nice, and it was very polite.
I'm okay with it. I mean, I'm not gonna say no.
Well, if you want to look around at the moonlight or find somewhere to sit and relax, please lead the way.
Very well then. I'll put us underneath a palm tree or something along the beach.
And do you guys want to fade to black at this point?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
Hey man, we don't need to fade to black. I have this.
All right, fair enough. All right, and as you guys fade to black, most of you head back to the ship.
Actually, Michael, can I do one thing before that occurs, though?
Oh, sure. What do you want to do?
I would just like to say that while it is just literally at this point a sleeping ballast, and me and O-Dub and Winchester still lying on the beach, I just want Winchester to be passing the fucking pipe back and forth with O-Dub.
Oh, yeah, and you guys eventually get pretty fucked up.
But as he goes, you know what, O-Dub, good chap? I think we did a pretty good job of getting everyone very loose tonight, wouldn't you say?
Oh, O-Dub and Winnie best at that. Good friends.
Indeed.
Can we get Ballast girlfriend, or...
He looks over at the sleeping Ballast. I honestly have no idea what he's in for.
Me neither. We should find out at some point.
Yeah, perhaps.
Let him sleep tonight, though. He seemed like he have good nap.
Yeah, well, indeed. Well, this is the first time I've actually seen him sleeping.
Yeah. I think he has hard life, but I think we make it better.
Yes, indeed, sir. And it's always good to have Miko back.
Yeah! I think Ballast is going to like Miko.
Indeed. You know, they're almost like the same person at points.
You know, that's... O-Dub agree.
Pass the blunt.
Pass is blunt. And as you guys kind of wind down your nights, Varinata.
How long have I been gone? I do have a nice walk of shame, though. Maybe with one of his, like, his shirts.
So Varinata, as he leads you up to the cabin, eventually he just says, come here, and just, like, picks you up.
Absolutely.
opens the door to the tropical cabin, throws you on the bed, and you are in for a wild, ravenous night.
Let's fucking go.
At one point, he does...
I demand a constitution saving throw.
Hold on, we're getting there. and he get at some point he kind of gives like that low sort of like lion growl roar thing. I want you to roll me a performance check.
Oh my god!
You're a bard.
He's giving you a free layup here.
Yeah.
Like, real.
Just don't.
You're like the only class that would bother to take performance as a thing.
I was like, you can't roll it. Who do you want to roll it?
They did not take performance as a proficiency.
Really? Well, They still have their jack of all trades, though, so you know.
Yeah, they got +7. It's pretty
exactly.
good.
Exactly. Pretty good modifier. Literally beyond anything you could do naturally.
So, Maggie, you said you didn't want Michael to roll it. Do you want one of us in the roll 20 to roll it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Who are you giving permission?
All right. Who wants the. Maggie, who do you trust to roll your performance check?
Keith.
Okay, Heath, I'm going to give... Do you have permission for Maggie's sheet?
No. I got permission for Lucius' sheet.
You could just roll a d20, and you said the modifier was +7?
Yeah, I could, yeah.
You could do that.
Sure,
why
roll
not?
The d20.
Please?
6. So, still 13.
I'm going to give you advantage because you're a bard. This is like a class feature, a hidden class feature, bard.
This is a hidden
18.
Class feature.
25.
Give me this one chance to bardic myself. Like,
You know what? Fuck it. You're high as fuck. I'm gonna give you this one opportunity to inspire yourself.
No. She gets so high that she just her ego transcends.
Yeah, I can't remember. Did they have guidance actually, or was that just Lucius?
Yeah, no, that's Lucius.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, sure, Varinata. Heath, if you want to roll her a d8, I'll let you inspire yourself.
Another four.
Let's fucking go.
So that's 29.
Hidden bard class feature securing the bag.
Varinata, you rock his world.
Let's.
Like, he gives out a full lion's roar at one point. And then I'm gonna ask you to make me a constitution saving throw.
Go on ahead.
Alright, here, I'll roll this one. Okay. Yeah, 13. You last a good while.
Did you just roll a d4?
I think he's rolling for what the lion-o did.
And the lion? He actually matches pace with you in terms of endurance. In terms of performance, he's pretty good in the sack. Like, well, not gonna lie, he is actually literally godly in the sack.
What did he roll,
bro? I got an F20. You're what? I'm not! I will take a picture of this shit right now.
I can't believe this.
It's official. Varinata has entered Bard Heaven. How do you feel about this, Maggie?
I'm overjoyed. Michael was asking me last night about so many questions about. It's like, you're a furry, right? And I'm like, yeah.
I'm like, yeah.
Damn, that's one hell of an icebreaker, Michael. Walk up. You're a furry, right? Like.
Well, we were talking a little bit before that.
I mean, let's be honest. The first character NPC they hit on was the lion character at the gladiatorial.
Which is why I was suspicious. Here's the natural 20.
I was drinking my Coke, dog.
After that, it was the fucking dragon.
Yeah.
Varinot, you have a very good night. You have a very, very good night.
That's beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome. And you wake up the next morning in this cozy cabin. Feel free to grab one of his shirts as a prize or something.
Absolutely, absolutely.
I'm surprised this guy has shirts, to be honest.
Yeah, he shouldn't own a single shirt. She needs to grab something else.
Well, you know, he has them for when he leaves. You know, he doesn't really wear a shirt when he's here. Yeah. Feel free to grab your prize.
Grabs his robe, takes off.
Yes, the big.
You start getting ready, and as you're kind of like, you're starting to leave the door, he kind of like wakes up and he's like, wait. I'll see you again, alright?
Oh, yeah, for sure. This is great.
Hey. Call me anytime.
Hit you up when I'm near.
You do, and. Now we will cut the scene there, and we will call it a session.
God, I just love the idea that now that Winchester is the only registered pilot in the group, I have to be the booty call runner.
God. That's beautiful stuff. Thank you.
I messaged Yoshi this, but it's like, man, I forgot what a beach episode entailed.
Oh yeah, man, 9 out of 10 times the Anim Sun sort of weird frex, sex orgy concept.
So how'd you guys enjoy your beach episode?
Twas fun, Michael. Thank you for letting my character get everybody high as fuck. I think that led to some great moments.
Yeah. I'm glad you guys had fun. So question for you, Eric, real quick.
He's still sleeping.
Real.
Eric?
Yes?
So, you now have the opportunity to play either Miko or Ballas, never at the same time. At least taking them out onto missions and stuff at the same time.
Of course.
So, we'll get to that later, but you can basically pick and choose who you want to send out for whatever missions from now on.
Roger that.
Oh, wow.
Definitely gives us an edge.
He gets the character select screen, man.
Beautiful.
Well, I can't make a choice between who I want to, like, if he did want to make me, like, have to choose between her two. both me and the rest of the party aren't sure what Mikkel had to go through in the time he's been away, so we don't know how he's been affected by that.
Yeah, we'll get to that next
session. So I haven't been able to make an educated choice when it comes to that.
We'll get to that next session.
Yeah.
Beautiful stuff.
Yeah, good game, Michael. Lots of fun.
Thanks. Did you guys enjoy any particular part, or just enjoy just fucking around for a bit?
That was just nice to fuck around, honestly.
Yeah.
Some of the players' case is literal, but...
Maggie, I do apologize for targeting you, like,
No wonder you were so upset that Maggie might not have made it tonight, man. Like, there is...
I had this plan.
Be like, what's going on here?
Speaking as a DM that lost an opportunity with one of his players, like, Michael, you remember Ares' character in Escape from Draelic Mountain?
Yeah, I remember that.
So I had an episode set up where they were supposed to meet an Ice Fae woman, and it was a trap for Ares, but she didn't show up for the game.
Yeah, I remember you telling me about that one.
Yeah, so...
Otlius get fucked over by that?
Yeah, well, Otlius ended up being the sacrifice, and then again, mind controlled.
Veronata, by the way, Maggie, if you want to add the moniker of Lionfucker at some point onto, like, either Veronata or something.
Veronata the Lionfucker.
That's beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome. I was like, oh, this is going to be hilarious.
I was like confused why you wanted it to be a surprise. I was like, what's gonna be a surprise about this random guy at this beach?
God, I was laughing my ass off though to fucking Winchester and Oda being the matchmakers tonight.
I love the story.